Well, that was fun, wasn't it? That was James's idea. The person who just asked whose idea was this song. Of course that was James's idea. Because he believes in magic. In a young girl's heart, apparently. I guess I can take those off. How's it going, everybody? Oh, hey, Alex, what's up?
I found out a cool thing.
What's that?
Do you know why some of the numbers are screwed up?
Why's that?
Because the number as printed on the file type is sometimes different from the actual date recorded.
Oh, that sucks. So the spreadsheet's been helpful already?
Yes.
Sweet!
Thanks, everyone!
I don't know if you guys heard that. That was Alex talking about how handy the spreadsheet that you all worked on was. Yeah, I got mad beard today. I need to trim this bad boy. Mm-hmm. Null Rush, there's a... I put out a spreadsheet to get you guys to help out with recording, like, what episode... Like, what we stream and when, so that we know what we haven't put up on the replay channel or not. The Loading Ready Live... Boop, boop, boop. Replay channel, so... What? Assisting Jarl, what? 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 A clip of us got what? And Itadzu has just subscribed, and that's not showing up on here, because this doesn't have the... For some reason, this doesn't have the, Oh, look, we just went live. This doesn't have the, Sub notifier. So, Itadzu, hello, welcome, thank you, and what is this? What is this? Hang on. Let's watch this together. Just a moment. Boop. Wait. There it is. What is this?
James, let's count it down. Female video game characters and the amazing women in real life that they're based on are awesome and worth celebrating. There's GLaDOS, Zelda, Ellie, Lily from Psychonauts, even the yoga instructor from the upcoming Smash Brothers. But many developers, for some crazy reason,
sweet. It's a little clip of female characters. That's so cool.
In their games. At E3 this year, there was a bit of a brouhaha when a representative from Ubisoft said that the company had scrapped plans for playable female characters in Assassin's Creed Unity multiplayer.
Can you play as a female character?
Oh, no.
Why not?
We didn't prioritize for that level of customization.
Their reasoning was that adding a female character would double
the workload. Oh, nice, and there's a link to it as well.
But then Jonathan Cooper, an animator at Naughty Dog, formerly of Ubisoft, countered that adding a female character would have been pretty easy to do, like a couple days of work. And then Ubisoft just... September 1993.
That's cool. the Lovin' Spoonful. I believe in magic, do you? James will be back, by the way. He's just going to the bathroom because he's been here since... what beard game? What beard game is that? Whoa. Sick beard game, Lone Bard. Admiral Mamo, where'd that straw poll go? We finally made it. We got mentioned by PBS. Online. Hello! Not the living spoonful, the lovin' spoonful. There it is. Thank you, Stalker Soldiers. That can't be the right one. Is that the right one? I don't know. But the straw poll is pretty... Everyone seems to have their own, apparently. It's pretty well tied. What do you want to do? We can just do whatever. Nirvana's really doesn't want us to do Modern Masters.
Yeah, I'm down for vintage. I mean, vintage means we can open power, and that seems like fun.
We can go back.
We haven't actually done that yet.
We can go back here for now.
Yeah.
That's true.
Let's just do vintage. Well, we only... Yeah. Getting there.
Oh, well, wait. There are seven in the queue, so... Ah! Oh.
Boil Ancient Tomb, eh?
Well. Huh?
Yeah.
Storming out. I mean, Ancient Tomb is, it's like a Sol Ring.
Sort of. It's like a hurt you Sol Ring.
Do the thing. We will do the thing. Fire Blast is really good.
Yeah.
Reanimate's real good. Man, a lot of good options here, actually. I don't know what to take. I just don't know. No, I don't know. Why did I...
Sorry, we were watching the PBS YouTube channel did their like PBS game show or whatever about...
Oh, yeah, we gotta pick the card, I guess. I think it's like Tomb or Fire Blast.
Let's take Fire Blast.
Alright. About female video game characters, and they used a clip of our sketch.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and linked to the channel, which is nice. Oh my god! We could have taken Future Sight into High Tide.
Yeah. We could take the actual slide and just do the slide deck.
We could just try to slide it up.
I mean, there's also, like...
Just slide
there's
it.
There's a Manowar. I mean, Psychotog is obviously Manowar, very,
Psychotog,
very good.
Manowar, Psychotog, but I've never played the slide deck. I've seen it.
Yeah? Okay. Well, it's early enough that we can absolutely build around it, so...
Let's do it. Let's slide.
What's the red one?
Slide over here. Whoa. Not that again. What's the red what?
What's the red cycle? In
oh, Lightning Rift.
Yeah.
Oh, Lightning Rift is filthy. So there's Fof. No. That's not right for Death Slide. There's Terra's Faithful, which is a good slide target. I don't think that works with the Astral Slide. Is it like Factor Fiction?
What does the dragon do?
You remember this guy?
Oh, right. Yeah. No, this guy's stupid. We're not doing that. Yeah, I mean, the Faithful goes in Slide.
Yeah?
But I mean...
Do we just want to be, like, Red, White, Slide?
Yeah. I'm down with Red, White, Slide.
All right. Yeah, Fof is fine, but... Not fine. Fof is a very, 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 very good spell, but... Eh. Whatever. Let's do this. What do you mean we're not necessarily slide? This is the only card you need to be in slide. Blessing. I think.
I mean, there's also a Judgment.
Another Faithful. I'm going to take the Blessing, because it cycles, and it's good otherwise.
Sounds good.
Fof is really good in slide, it's true. But... Ooh!
That's kind of fun.
Spicy.
We
can keep...
Keep just going with the...
Keep resetting the Nomad?
Yeah.
Although... This is a mythic, too. Is this good? How do you do this? How do you abuse this in this format? Skipping Factor Fiction? I'll let it slide this time. Ooh, can you tweet?
Yeah.
Sweet. I mean, I'm going to take the Geddon, but how do we, like... You know what, whatever. Get in. Get in, Geddon. Armageddon. Yeah! You abuse Armageddon by going aggro. Well, alright. Please show this to Alex. He requested it. I can't claim it, though.
Nice.
Alex Stacey, frequent last words. With a boar behind it. Holy crap. Did you draw this? This is amazing. No, I can't claim it, though. Who drew this? That's really sweet. Can you do that? No, you can only slide creatures. That would be funny, though. Armageddon was one of the first video Loading Ready Run videos I ever saw. Well, hey there, sailor. So Goblins is open,
torch.
For whatever that matters, but just going to take Torch. There's nothing here that cycles, and Torch is really good, so get in. What the? Strip Mine? Strip Mine with Armageddon? Right? I mean, What else are we taking here? Thopter Squadron? Let's...
Yeah, let's hit this trip.
Do-do-do-do. We're the fun police. I'm with you, Hasco. I love goblins. If this was just me drafting, I'd probably be drafting goblins right now, but everyone's drafting goblin decks, so... Not forcing Astral Slide, we got past it. I mean, we're kind of forcing it. It's a turnabout also, so Storm is open.
Yeah, just start Spark Spray though. Yep, Burrows is continuing to beat face. That just kind of just works.
It's really nice. I like that. Sorry, I missed it. Did someone say who drew that thing of Alex? I gotta show it to him. Take the Lotus? All right. If there's a Black Lotus, we'll probably take it. I don't know if it's great in this deck, but we'll think about it.
Spray has to be the pick.
Scrivener is good in Slide, actually. Slide can be good in the red, white, and blue.
Yeah, I think you just take the...
Step. The cycling lands are very good.
Yep.
Oh, that was Habtorn Epsilon? Oh, that's sick. I gotta show that to Alex. Actually, is Alex still here?
I think so. Just mute the mic real quick.
I did that so you wouldn't hear me screaming at Alex. Oh. Right, there's a pack.
All these cards are poop.
This better be worth coming away from an input-output error.
I guess I'm gonna take the Seal of Cleansing.
What?
It's so beautiful. I like the snake and the bombs and shit.
I like the laser sight on your forehead.
I like and the laser sight in your forehead.
Oh, that's my favorite.
Like you're about to get bored right out.
Oh man.
Do I take drill sergeant or do I take a
replied that to my Twitter because I'm gonna reblog the shit out of that.
That's super good.
That's so fantastic. That is. Even better than I was expecting. We have the best fans.
Quick.
I don't care.
All right.
Thanks, guys.
No worries. Hey, Strand Jack, how's it going?
Sure. Tangle, go away. Sure.
It's like the only combat trick in this format.
There aren't many.
Just staunchly refusing to take goblins. That's not quite what we're doing, but still. Look at the filthy filth police we can do. No one gets lands. Any of you.
We got the Astral Stride, so we want one more of those.
We've got four
cycle cards?
Four cycle cards.
Okay.
We've got four cycling cards. That's fine, actually.
Yeah.
We got four cycling cards and a really good slide target in our Taros Faithful. Now we need to start doing some other stuff. Wow. There's a lot of stuff going on here. What's this?
I haven't seen that card.
Other creatures you control get +1/+1.
Yeah. It's kind of cool, actually.
That seems reasonable.
There's also a Battle Screech.
There's a Battle Screech foil.
Yeah.
Forgotten Cave. Gilded Light. Kindle. Phantom Nomad.
And the Scrivs.
That's a tough call, actually, but I don't know. Probably this thing?
Could fall.
Like, Kongming seems pretty sweet.
Other people are saying Screech, though.
I mean, Battle Screech is really good. This guy's a little... He's a little Anthem. Look at little Anthem.
I mean, we only have two creatures right now.
Oh, fine. What's up, Rune 678? Rone? Screech loves Armageddon? That's true.
Oh, yeah.
That is true.
Yeah.
Alright. Crater Hellion.
Nope.
Chain Lightning.
Chain Lightning is
another secluded step. Might just be Chain Lightning.
I think it's just Chain Lightning, right?
Just kill a thing. Want to get some Phantom Nomads. Emerald Mamo says, no.
Too bad. We took the Battle Screech. The Battle Screech
in Armor. I don't think Kong Ming has a good chance of wheeling.
Oh, yeah, I doubt it would wheel, but...
I don't think this is a Hellion deck, though. Take the Crater Hellion right now. There's no way this is a Hellion deck.
No, it is.
Hellion and slide,
yeah.
But then we have to keep paying Echo over and over again. That's so bad. I'm gonna take this thing. Whoa!
Beetleback.
That's good with slide. Two of these, and we might get one back out of that.
Yep.
Tethers. Laquatus is champion. So good.
Yeah, that card is very good. But yeah, Chief. E's Chief.
EBC.
Crap. I guess just the Harrier.
I guess. Like, we're not necessarily in blue yet, so I don't really want to do the sandbar.
I don't want to waste that.
Toking Tethers is another really good cycle card, but... Prospero, welcome to Vintage Masters. Another Chain Lightning.
Yep.
Yippers.
Yeah, take another Chain Lightning.
So no one else is in red, I guess. What exactly is Slide? Sorry, so this card, Astral Slide. Probably going to take Bodyguard here. Or like the Kenai, even. We should probably take a blue cycling card. I don't know. Maybe not. So Astral Slide is whenever a player cycles a card, you get to exile a creature and return it back at the beginning of the end step. Take the Bodyguard. So with this guy, we gain 4 life every time he enters the battlefield. With this guy, we get 2 little goblins. The idea is you get their creatures out of the way and you abuse your own creatures.
Yeah.
So we
the Aven cycles colorless cycle. That's not bad.
Yeah.
We just take that, and if we end up with a little bit of blue, then we're blue. I'm okay with that.
All right. How is him still here? That's a great question. So it's like a 2 mana colorless cycler. I really want to open Lightning Rift. Yeah. Lightning Rift is disgusting. So Lightning Rift is kind of like Astral Slide. Whenever you cycle a card, you can pay 1, just 1 colorless, to deal 2 damage to something. It's really powerful. I think we're getting cut on the cycle lands. I could be wrong.
As you say that, cycle land. Armadillo Cloak, jeez.
Do we want the land or the blessing?
Probably the blessing.
Like they both cycle for a single white mana.
Yeah, and that just has.
And this could also be a spell.
Yep.
What do you guys think here? Step or blessing? I don't actually know which way this goes. Lightning Rift isn't necessarily better than Slide. I think it depends on the other stuff you have in your deck.
Blessing, land, cloak. Land, blessing, 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 blessing. Yeah, blessing. Take the blessing.
You'll
there we go. We get the step.
Yeah.
Other pretty good
cards,
though.
You only pay Echo once. Not if you blink it. Oh, blessing your screeches and goblin tokens? That's true. That's the idea, Prospero. The deck only abuses cycling because of Astral Slide. So when we cycle, we get to blink something, and we've got several creatures...
That have
2, I guess, just for now. Is it just the 2?
Right,
well, we got a couple creatures. The hope is you get several creatures that have Enter the Battlefield effects. The deuce that I don't.
No, I don't want that.
This only cycles for 1. The Scrivener's still here. Wowie. Alright, that's probably enough of the land.
Yeah.
Creatures in Pack 3. Good call. Good call. Yeah, if you slide an Echo creature, you have to keep paying the Echo. It's not great. I'm going to take this Choking Tethers, I think, over another Wall of Diffusion.
Yep, that's fine.
It even put it where I wanted it to, cycling on the 2 drops.
Wait, what?
All right. Well, we got plenty of that stuff. I'm gonna put all our land over here. The nice thing is you get to play more draft picks. The nice thing about when you're in a position where you want to be taking land is you get to play more of your draft picks than other people.
Libra has just subscribed.
Libra has just subscribed, or Libra?
Libra. Oh yeah, I guess.
Libra might be an I. We'll say Libra. Libra, thank you for subscribing. Welcome.
I'll take that.
Take a Caldera Lake.
I'll take a Falter.
We're not ever going to be. Ah, that's good against our Battle Screech.
Sub hut! Also, Lurbot is back. We're missing one. We're at storm count of 7 today.
Sweet.
Damn it! Well, so much for
Strix is a rare in this?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
So much for our.
No power for us. So, also, Bodyguard. General, Cave, Owl Familiar. I guess we just take the Bodyguard.
Probably.
I mean, we're going to have a couple goblins, but I want to have some more white creatures for Screech times.
Yeah.
So I think we just take the Bodyguard. I agree with you, Nirvana. That pack was poopy. Yeah, Bufinka dropping all them Steam keys in the chat there.
Deranged Hermit, oh god. Another Faithful, I guess?
Another Faithful, Deathblade, Emissary. These are really good cards. Yeah, I guess take another Faithful. What the? It's getting all confused because I was moving the 4-drops around.
There we go.
Put this over here. Whatever, we'll leave those for now. Whatever, we'll let you do it the way you want. I know, sliding a Dark Hatchling? That'd be so good. This is tighter than usual.
It was, too, yeah.
Which is fine. I'm gonna get our face right up in your biz. Oh, there's a pack here. Whoops. Hey!
Archangel.
Boop.
There's a chief. There's a solar blast.
I want all these cards. I want all of these cards. Huh. I think it's Beetleback. Hey guys, first time watching the stream, but I'm a huge fan. Well, hey! Hey, Kenisga?
I think, yeah, just Chief, right?
The point is, welcome. Thank you for watching.
Yeah.
We did not get the Kongming back, no.
No. Take the Chief.
Take the conspiracy card that lets you take the whole pack? No kidding.
Wall, Exile, Trooper, probably?
Probably just Trooper.
Yep.
We have other removal,
and I don't want another wall.
We want low.
Yeah, we need some more creatures that can attack. Boo! Wow, all these cards are not very good.
Do we play more walls? Just to stop the aggro plan?
Maybe.
Like, we're going to be attritioning people out, I think. Maybe, maybe not, I don't know. We're not going to take Baron more, we're never going to play it. Go on patrol. Is Seal good against... I guess Seal's good against us, but I'd rather take a creature. We've only got 9 of them. I think I'll take this thing.
Sure.
We have a Seal in the sideboard. Whoa! Probably another Trooper. I think we have enough... Cycling lands?
Yeah, I don't want another
one. I think I'd like another Trooper.
Yeah.
And the Aftershock and Gilded Light and stuff are good. Jeez. Ooh!
Yep. That's a...
Also good.
Yeah.
Sparkspray,
yeah.
This guy could be really good in this deck.
Yep. I like it. Alright, we need to start cutting cards. Just another... I mean...
Deathblade? We don't really abuse it. No, I think we're okay with these creatures. Probably actually cut choking tethers.
Yeah.
Then we don't have to actually run blue. We'll cut the sandbars and the caldera lake, and then we'll still have one... We'll have four... Actually, if we take this, we'll have five cycle lands plus all those things.
Yeah.
All right. Stoic Champion seems more like Swole Champion. This deck might do something.
It is not the best slide deck, but it's not the worst, I think. I don't know, maybe it is. Jeez. Just take the afterlife. We don't need it.
How many cycling things do we have? One, two, three, four.
And then all
five,
of the
six,
lands.
Five, six, seven, eight, nine.
If we want, yeah.
Well, we might want the cave. To be honest.
Go for it.
Get in. Why not? Sure.
Cut that.
Cut the elite?
Yeah. I think that's our deck right now.
Mana prism. We don't need the mana prism.
Yeah, you can cut that out too.
Get Deathblade can get back in. Oh, wow. Templar, I think.
Probably just
as a creature. Also, it cycles if we need it, but probably just as a creature. Then we can cut Kenai even.
Take the exile now.
Yeah, definitely. Because I think we're fine on dudes now. And Mystic Zeal, it's cool and all. Especially if we're going to be filling up our graveyard with cycling cards.
Maybe that's better.
Like, we got some removal.
Yeah, screw that. Take this out.
Alright.
Sure.
yeah. Wow. I guess this. We don't need another one of these. We're not necessarily going to main deck that, but we might. I kind of dig how this came together, to be honest. Iron Man Phoenix, I have not had a chance to draft M15 yet. So how many cyclers do we have? One, two, three, four. I'm just double checking. Four. Oops. Five, six. 7, 8, 9, 10. Alright, that seems alright. 10 cycling cards. And we also have a strip mine.
For funsies. Yeah.
Deck name suggestions.
Jesus.
Strip and slide.
I like strip and slide.
Light cycle. Sweet. Ugly step sifter.
That one's really good.
The 12 step program. My super ex-hurling friend. What? Ugly step sifter. Yeah, we got Armageddon and strip mine for added hate all your stuff value. Is this an Armageddon deck? I don't know. Dude, I don't know.
I mean, yeah. Armageddon plus Fire Blast is pretty awkward, but that's fine.
Get on with it. All right, so what is it? What is this suggesting? 10-7 for white.
Yeah, that's probably right.
I guess it's like these guys are more awkward with less white, but we really want to be hit double red for these guys. But we have plenty of ways to cycle through the deck. So, okay, so 10-7 for white. Except we got a strip mine in there as well.
That comes out with the
of the white. So like that?
Yeah.
cha-cha, real smooth. So, this one?
Yeah, I like stuff. So.
Actually, I guess it's... Is it like this?
If you do that, there's no spaces, I don't think, between... Isn't it all just one big, giant, stupid word?
I don't think so.
Like, slip and slide. Is there... I didn't think there was spaces.
I think it's like this. We can correct that. Please do not play the Casper slide on stream. Okay. Hey guys, what did we make? I don't know what we made. We made this.
It's that actually.
Okay.
That's what Wikipedia says.
Actually, I guess it should be this, shouldn't it? It should be.
Yeah, P E, and then apostrophe capital N. There we go.
Like that.
That's.
There we go.
That is proper formatting.
Okay,
according to this.
We found it. We got there. Hosk, why do you keep asking these questions? I don't understand.
No, Hosk, I'm not going to move to Oklahoma and get a job writing the little quirky phrases on Taco Bell sauce packets. Although that does sound amazing. That sounds like a pretty sweet job. But no, it's not true.
We don't have 12 removals, though.
It's true, we don't. Alright, let's play magic.
I submitted.
Oh, did you?
I'm waiting. We're waiting on them now.
Alright.
Oh, you guys want me to talk about the salty opponent? All right.
Beam Dog Redemption Code for...
So, I didn't... Oh. It was not my best deck. I'm going to be perfectly clear. I did not draft the best deck I've ever drafted. It was not great. It was a blue-white, sort of mid-rangey deck. It was fine. It definitely was missing a bunch of key things that it needed. And I splashed black for Siren of the Silent Song, because I was, you know, like, it was mostly blue-white flyers, and so I splashed off of a swamp and a Traveler's Amulet for that, and for just for value, the activation of Scholar of Athreos, because I figured, well, it's better if you have more than one swamp, but I don't know, maybe it'll be relevant. I was sort of grasping for playables. Not my best. Game one, my opponent just goes, like, asphyxiate, asphyxiate, bounce, bounce, kill, lash. Like, just kills all my dudes, just rolls me. Game two, he's stuck on land a little bit, and I'm able to make some good plays and get round and punch him in the face. And then game three, we're just sort of, we're fighting back and forth. It's going okay. It's getting very, very close. He's got, I've got some flyers, but he's got, like, he has a lot of Vaporkin and a Horizon Scholar and a Shipwreck Singer, and my guys are really loose to it. Although he did make a mistake in game two. He let all the combat damage resolve and then waited until, like, I attacked, or he forced my Chorus of the Tides to attack and blocked with his, Coastline Chimera, the 1/5, and I had a Battlewise Valor, so I was waiting for him to activate Shipwreck Singer to give my guy -1/-1, meaning that his guy would have eaten my guy, so then I would have cast Battlewise Valor and instead eaten his guy. And he didn't do it, and I was like, oh, okay, then I'll cast my 5-drop. And so in my second main, after I was tapped out, he activates the Shipwreck Singer to give attacking creatures -1/-1. But it's second main. The creature isn't attacking anymore, so nothing happened. So I was like, that's weird. But then game three, we're in this situation where, like, he's forcing my guys to attack so they can't block. So, like, he's forcing my Starfish to attack. Starfish, all-star, by the way, obviously. Forcing it to attack so it can't block his random little 2/1s on the ground. And the situation is, he's at 2. I'm at 7. He's got 9 power on the board. And all my guys are tapped out. When I scry, I top the Scholar of Athreos. So, second main, I play the Scholar, it's my only untapped creature, I pass the turn, and I have 3 mana open with the black. And so, the situation is, unless he has something, he attacks with all his guys, I block with my Scholar, meaning I only take 7, I activate the Scholar, I go to 1, and he goes to 1, and then I untap, and I can kill him with the Scholar. So he attacks with everything, I block, I activate the Scholar, I go to 8, and then he pauses, and nothing happens. Oh, of course, I was scrying before it was forced to attack, absolutely. So it doesn't... He just pauses. And then I get this game challenge from him. I get challenged to a vintage game from him where he's just screaming at me in the game description, like in the challenge. He's just in all caps. He's super angry. And so in the game chat, I'm like, why did you make a game to do that? I mean, I appreciate the effort, I guess. And he's like, I'm permanently muted or something. So fuck you. And I'm like, okay. So one, I didn't know you could do that. I didn't know that people could get like just
permamuted.
Just like you aren't allowed to chat. I didn't know they could do that to people.
I feel like if you get banned, if you're permanently muted, you should be just go that one step further and just be banned.
Right?
Like if you're so bad that you've been squelched to never speak again.
Yeah. So here's the conversation. You're a piece of luck turd.
I like luck turd.
My deck is better than yours, but you luck sagged hard this one. Like you made a new game. For what it's worth, I agree your deck is better. It was. I am muted indefinitely, so fuck you. I'm like, all right. You don't deserve to win. Your deck is garbage and won't make the final round. Concede to me, and I'll give you 2 boosters. I know I will win. That's totally not allowed.
Yep.
That is collusion. You will lose in round 2, mark my words. Think, if you concede, you get 2 boosters from me. Otherwise, you auto-lose in round 2. I have 12x removals in my deck. And I'm like, no. Fine, go fuck yourself. I'll laugh to watch you losing round 2, idiot. I'm like, yeah, you're probably right. Look at you, one swamp. Lol, how lucky are you? You won't be lucky like this again. Horrible deck design and poor draft skill. I admit it was a bad draft. But splashing off of a swamp and a traveler's amulet is not weird.
Also, why so salty, man?
And then go lose in round 2.
I feel like this guy's a little bit beyond salty.
Yeah, and I did. I did lose in round 2. But the games were really, really close. I'll tell you about the games afterwards. But this is my favorite comment. This fellow about to have another conversation he isn't going to like. Ooh, worth cast dispense justice. I didn't see that. Nice. Nice, I dig it.
All right.
Looks like someone let their deck building go to time. Yeah, we'll play first.
Not with that. That's better.
Ooh, yeah, look at that.
We got our astral slide.
Oh, we do. So the question becomes...
These 2 lands we want to just play, right?
Probably.
We don't want to, because...
We can Plains and Cycle Step right away.
Yeah, that's true.
And I don't know. James, how did you properly balance the colors when constructing your cube?
I followed somebody else's cube. That's something that terrified me and I don't have the time for, is actually making sure that the cube is balanced, because that's very important when building a cube. You don't want to build a cube where one color just completely outclasses every other color. And that's why I steal from smart people who know what they're doing.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a better cube for it.
I'm probably just going to play the cave then, so we can get, hopefully, turn 3 slide and just start doing gross things.
Mm-hmm.
So.
That being said, if you head over to, I can't remember if it's the MTG Cube, there's an MTG Cube subreddit, and there will be tons of people there who love helping you out. Draw a card, sounds mm-hmm. fine. And helping you, you know, make your cube as good as it can be, so.
Oh, sick.
Okay.
That's good, we get to save this. Jay Wiley was asking, what's the difference between collusion and splitting? Very, very simple. Typically, splitting only happens in the last round. Depending on the tournament, it can happen at other levels, but not on Magic Online. Splitting is like, you're in the finals, and you say, do you want to split? And your opponent says yes, and that's it.
You can
split evenly. Collusion is what this guy was doing, which is saying, I will basically pay you in product. I will pay you to concede to me.
Yeah.
Which you're not allowed to do. It's not actually as fine a line as it sounds. I was really hoping for Tarot's Faithful there. I'm just gonna cast Spark Spray and see if he wants to save his guy.
Yeah.
Alright. God, do I just hold the rest of this?
I would think so.
I can cycle all of these things.
Yeah.
Oh, can you not see the whole... Oh, that's as much as you can see. That's how we... actually, the window's slightly not quite there. That's the bottom of the window. We move the hand down a little bit so you can see more of the...
The battlefield.
Battlefield. Do we plane cycle? I guess. Maybe we should just do that.
Yeah.
In case Battle Screech? Sure. All right, let's do that. Plane cycle, and then we can actually play it, too. Doink, doink, doink. Luck turd. Luck turd would make a good button. What's this? Another Skywing Aven. All right. All right, let's get some stuff. Action.
Well, he is off his land, too.
Do we just strip him.
I think we just do it.
Yeah.
Because...
Or do we wait till we...
I mean, maybe we wait to see maybe a second color?
He's already behind on land. We should probably just do it.
Yeah, I mean... I don't know. Seconding a luck turd button?
No, Nirvana says do it.
We do need a new button.
You monsters.
I guess we do it. Yeah, I mean, he's off his land, so...
All right. Foxmar, no, when we... I really need to. It's super bad that we haven't gotten the next button in yet. Seconding luck turd button. Lord Hosk, I'm going to learn to cross-stitch so I can do the entire conversation. Sweet, he's still off the land, apparently. We're taking some damage, that's fine. Just wait till we start...
I mean, we could have cycled, couldn't we?
We could have. Okay. I don't really want to blink that in this case.
No, because then it untaps.
Sweet.
Wait, did he just land cycle and not play a land?
Yes.
Why? What?
Because he's looking for another color, I guess? Yeah.
But you cycle for a blue, right?
Mm-hmm.
By doing that? So he drew a plane or an island there.
No, it's not island cycling. It's just... He's just drawing
cycling.
A card.
Drawing a card. Right.
All right, so next turn we get to start going totally ham with Tarot's Faithful. Plu Noir, I like it fine. Like, there's a bunch of problems with it, obviously, but it's fine. Filthy. Oh, sick. All right. And it's the end step?
Yeah.
Cool. I'm gonna cycle it now then. Whoop! Dun 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 dun. Always yield, but not necessarily always yes. Oh, what's this?
Stifle?
Oh, he was waiting for me. Okay. Sure, I guess. It doesn't really matter. All right, I'm not going to blink the gust cloak. No, it's fine. Okay. He was waiting for me to already have used the cycle so that we weren't getting value off that.
Yep.
So he's going looking for red. Interesting. And we draw
another blessing.
Sick.
More life.
Okay. Leak mana. That's not bad.
Ooh, he's got the wall.
Okay. I'm probably just going to start, like, aggressively blinking his Skywing Haven. Or do we just blink this forever?
I think we just keep blinking that forever, right?
We can do both. Gas. It's not really gas.
Not really gas.
Not really gas.
It's pretty bad, actually.
Just the aggro blinks. Get in for damage. That really delays his aggression on us.
Yeah, I guess so.
All right, let's do it. Cycle, and we get to do this. Get out. Yes.
Okay.
Draw planes. No, that's fine.
Yep. I'd like other things, though. Array wall.
I guess I should have tapped double red for that so I could blink our faithful.
Blink it.
Like.
I think you have to blink it.
Don't we just. Yeah.
I think so.
All right.
It's kind of the only thing that we have to win right now. Like, we kind of need it.
Oh, sick. That'll help a lot, actually.
Yeah, he can block with the wall.
Damn it! This is actually going to be a really, really slow game. Oh, thank goodness. That'll help a lot.
Yep.
All right.
Now we need lots more cycle cards.
Well, we're gonna blink Beetle back at the end of his turn.
Oh, is the blessing only one to blink or
yep.
Cycle? No, I thought it was two for some reason.
Nope.
Sick.
Yeah. This game will be so slow, I can hear the grinding. No kidding. Do any of you have decks you just don't play against people you like? Not really.
Not really, no.
Pillaging Horde? Wow. All right. Oh, we can really F him up with that.
You can empty his whole hand with it.
Oh my god. Dude, why would you play that against us? I mean, not why would you main deck that? Why would you resolve that against us? Okay, so
do we do that and just empty his freaking hand, or do we make some more 1/1s?
Oh wait, is it the next end step? Ooh, whoops. So this is actually, we do this now.
It comes back.
It comes back at the end of our turn.
Oh, is it our turn?
Yeah. No, it's the beginning of the next end step. We're already in the beginning of the next end step.
Right, yeah.
So, yeah, let's just blink it now.
Yeah.
Then we can crash in with a bunch of guys. The fun police have no shame. No kidding.
Yes.
Later.
And draw a card. What? Come on! Give us better cards. You sons of bitches.
Well, we've been drawing plenty of good stuff. Alright.
Yeah.
Actually, I'm going to leave one goblin back, because he's going to get the pillaging horde back.
That's true.
So he'll have a 5-5. So he takes 4 here. We do not have Eternal Dragon, though. Do I just hold these lands in case we get Armageddon?
Yes.
Alright.
There's nothing in our deck that requires... We have... I don't think we have anything that casts for more than... 5, do we?
God, the pillaging horde is so gross.
Bye, choking tethers.
So he randomly discarded a solar blast last turn and then a choking tethers. Oh my god.
It'd be really nice if we had.
That's true. Playing lands makes Karvex Torch better. That's true. That is true. Bouncing the horde was really filthy. We do have Fire Blast, yes. Alright. And I have no cycle plays. What a shame.
Ugh. Sons of bitches. I'm gonna play the mountain, I guess, now.
So this guy gets blocked.
You can attack with the Harrier.
Yeah.
I mean, he blocks. If he blocks, he blocks with the owl, so it dies.
Yep. You haven't won yet, but you're getting there. How many cyclers have we used? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
So we only have 3 left?
Is that true?
We came in this with 10, right?
I think so. Doink.
I mean, that's fine. We have lots of other ways to win here.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9... 10.
Yep. So we have only 3 cyclers left.
Maybe we should start playing lands for the torch.
We should, yeah. Play them out, at least.
Alright. There's no point in attacking with the trooper, because he has Wall of Diffusion, which can block creatures with shadow. Uh-oh!
Killer Whale gets bad.
Killer Whale, pretty bad. Wow, he's really trying to race us here. To be fair,
we draw a torch, we win.
That's true.
Well,
that'll help a lot.
That's helpful.
All right, I'm gonna swing with Gustcloak. So the question is, do we blink? Do we just blink the Tarot's Faithful
to gain some life?
To gain some we don't do it now. If we blink Killer Whale, he gets it back. Oh, he's tapping out. Scrivener.
Ooh, what's he get?
He could get any number of things. He could get Solar Blast, Choking Tethers, Kindle. Obsessive Search. Probably not getting Obsessive Search.
No. Cast Scrivener. Targets. Solar Blast.
Okay. Yeah, let's see how he attacks.
Yeah.
All right.
I mean, we can't block. So what are we? Are we sliding something here? He's tapped out.
We could blink the horde again.
Well, we could blink the horde, we could blink the whale. No, it doesn't matter, he can't give the whale flying.
If we blink the wall, like,
we win if we draw a torch right now. So,
right.
I feel like we definitely want to cycle here just to draw more cards.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, we need to cycle his end step. We need to go to the end to cycle.
Yeah.
It doesn't force him to discard. It's a card at random, so it might not hit the Solar Blast. But I think that's probably what we just do. We just do Pillaging Horde.
If we blink his wall, we can hit him for 4.
Yeah?
Don't slide now. Or we'll go to his end step, I guess.
Blinking the Chief doesn't do anything. Blinking the wall gets him to 3.
And then if we draw another Cycler, although that's not super likely, but we have
we only have 2 more
Cyclers. We have 2 Chain Lightnings and a Fire Blast.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Right? I mean, we have,
so I think,
we have a few ways of doing that.
I think we might blink the wall just to get him to 4. Or just to get him down to 3.
Yeah. Chief doesn't gives us 2 more 1/1s that I don't think do much, although he only has 4 blockers, and we attack next turn with... how much should we attack for, actually, if we do
if
that?
If we attack with everything?
Yeah.
With this out of the way?
If we were to blink the...
The Horde?
Well, we can't blink the Chief now, because that doesn't work.
I think we blink the wall. And
yeah,
get him,
blink the wall. Do it.
Because we have so many ways...
Yeah, that's fine. Yep.
To deal the last 3 damage.
Yeah, it is too late. Yeah, I realize that it's too late to blink the Chief.
Yeah, that's why I paused on his main phase.
Yeah. Like, we could have done that, and we would have had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5...
That is also good.
That's very good. That's better.
That is also just dead.
Yeah. And we can just hard cast it, too.
Yeah. Boink.
Sweet. Goat there. All right. So.
Didn't even need the Battle Screech. Okay, this deck is fun. This deck is super silly.
So,
I love it. Fun Police here. Hand over all of your fun. Gib fun. I subsist on your fun.
Is any of these cards... Is Aftershock good?
Is Falter good?
Nah, I don't...
Falter would have helped. In that instance, because of his friggin' wall.
I don't think I care that much, though.
No, probably not. Just Aftershock. I think we're okay.
Yeah.
Right. Have we done an Ing Shuffler button? Just Shuffler?
No, we could do that.
We should decide on what our next button's going to be before the end of the stream.
Yeah, I think we keep that, right?
Yeah, it doesn't do any of the cycling stuff, but it's just super aggressive and fine, so let's keep it. And our opponent mulligan to 6. Are they going to 5-5-5? Oh, they are going to 5-5-5.
Ooh, they did. Are they going to go to 4-4-4?
Oh,
they went to 4-4-4.
Is this going to be the 3-2-1 scoop?
Yeah.
Oh, darn, all right. Mulligan to 4. All right, let's not lose.
So do we just play the Forgotten Cave here? So we have Chain Lightning up?
So the option is... Play the Cave, turn 2 Trooper, or play the Plains, turn 2 Champion.
The thing is that...
We have a cycle now.
Yeah.
I think I want to have some red source just in case.
Yeah, because, I mean, we kill anything he plays, and that puts him... probably slows him way down.
So we'll start out with the Trooper. We'll get the Champion down a turn later.
I think we're in pretty good shape, so... Stark and Turner Fun Police.
Stark, Turner, Fun Police. Oh, well, the Champion seems a lot better now that we've drawn runner cycling.
Yeah.
We'll get it down next turn. Man, that would actually be really filthy. We just bash.
Bash for 6 next turn? We could have bashed for 6 next turn?
Yeah.
Oh, well. He's not doing anything.
Especially off the land.
Yeah, he's... Okay.
Well.
Feel pretty good about this. Oh my god, we could bash for 8...
No, because we can't do all that. But we're going to play the Champion here, and the next turn we're going to go completely ham.
No, but next turn we can give him +6/+6, can't we?
Yeah.
Oh, no, we can't.
Unless
we need
he has, like, Counterspell.
I mean, we're not playing around Counterspell. He mulliganed the four.
If he's got it, he's got it.
If he's got it, he's got it, then yeah.
All right, I'm going to hold the step. Thieves Nexus, that's actually from Kenji. Doc picked it up from Kenji.
Oh, this sucks. Okay, this isn't...
Dude, I'm so Planes? Sorry.
Planes means we could triple cycle.
Ooh, what's he doing in our upkeep? Cycle choking tethers? Nope. All right.
More cycle.
Yeah, I'm just doing it.
Yeah. Sweet. Ugh.
Dude.
Just
oh.
Die.
Oh.
End of turn.
Yep. Cycling Kenai.
Oh, God. Now it's an 8-8.
That's funny.
All right. I feel like the scoop is coming here. Oh.
Ooh. Ophidian. All right.
We can just blow that up.
We can. And we probably just will.
Draw another cycler.
Or a land, actually, because then we can still cycle twice. Just any untapped land? Alright. Kill the Ophidian.
Attack for 4, play trooper? Or attack for 6?
I think attack...
Play bodyguard.
Yeah, I think cycle this guy, you mean? Go look for a planes, play it, play bodyguard after combat? Yeah. Because we can still only cycle once.
Yep.
So.
Yeah. Dude, definitely
cycle.
I mean, I guess we could have done that before combat.
Yeah. That's
but
true.
I like this better. Just.
Thank you, Mr. Kid MTG. Please don't use all caps.
But
thank you.
If we could have killed him.
We are indeed at the moon base.
Like, if we could have cycled enough to kill him there, then sure. But we couldn't. I like just getting one extra creature. Plus, this way that protects our champion, which is lethal next turn. Hey!
That was not a real game.
That wasn't a real game. That sucks for our opponent. Oh, and somebody dropped, so now people are going to get buys. But
I
not
think,
us!
Well, someone did go to time on deck building, so that
might
have
might have just dropped out, yeah. Alright, guys, let's talk about Card Kingdom.
Let's talk about Card
Let's
Kingdom.
Let's talk about Card Kingdom. They are the sponsors of our weekly drafts, and we love them. And it's a good place to go and buy your Magic cards. I just got a shipment of Magic cards in the other day, most of which were actually for Alex, but that doesn't matter. I ordered them. They shipped within, like, 18 hours or something like that, and they were here pretty quickly thereafter.
They shipped so fast.
They shipped very, very fast. If it wasn't for the border that separates... the two of us, my cards would probably be here within, like, I can only imagine how awesome it is to live in the States and order for Card Kingdom, because you probably could order, like, on Monday, and they could probably be there on Tuesday if you order early enough, and Wednesday probably at the latest. And that's just amazing. Unfortunately, we have the border, so it slows it down a bit, but man, do they ship fast. They stand behind their product. They have competitive prices. They buy cards from you.
Real Gamer Cow says he's working up a sell order that's up to $700.
Nice. Yeah, I need to start working on mine as well, actually.
So if you live anywhere in the States, you can get your sealed product there if you want to draft or just crack into some packs like M15. But they'll ship singles anywhere in the world.
Yeah.
Also, deck boxes, sleeves, dice, also board games. If you're so inclined.
Again, in the United States.
Netrunner?
I think they can... ship it out.
What, the board games?
Yeah, they can't ship board games.
Why not?
I don't know.
They don't ship sealed Magic because of Wizards requirements.
Yeah, due to expected attritions.
Ah.
Yeah, I don't know why that is.
Must be something with the publishers.
Hey, if you go to Card Sleeves, and
you go to...
Next page.
Oh?
No, they should be at the... top, shouldn't they? They should just be after the Legion.
Maybe they're in the Legion. There it is. Boink.
There they are.
Limited resources sleeves.
Limited resources sleeves. So you can buy those guys.
I mean, while we're talking about sleeves.
You could also go buy our sleeves. But at Card Kingdom, you could also buy.
So where's the MTG accessories?
Look at that.
Yeah, these two sleeves. By the way, the diagram playmats have been ordered. They are coming.
Yay.
We are getting a refresh on them. And the missing sizes of the phases shirts.
Nice.
So we'll have those. They'll PAX certainly be ready before Prime.
Yes.
Certainly be ready before PAX Prime. So.
So go check out Card Kingdom. They're awesome. If you do order from them, please at the end of your order let them know that we sent you. Just type in "loading ready run sent us."
That helps them. It helps us.
Yeah, it's really helpful. Normally we do have buttons that you can get for free when you put in your order. We need to make new buttons. I'm up for like Ing Shuffler. We haven't done that, and I kind of like that.
Yeah.
So maybe we'll do that.
Should it be like a dash, I guess, like
dash ing
Shuffler, or like Shuffler? One of the long dashes.
Yeah, I think that would work.
All right, sweet.
So we should definitely.
I'll do that tonight.
Sweet.
I will set myself a reminder for when I get home.
So we'll get those ordered. Hopefully they'll be there by the end of next week if they can get them fast enough, and then we'll let you know on Twitter when they're ready to go, and that way you guys can get your orders in. How fast do you guys usually ship? Our stuff ships out
usually the next day, I think.
Pretty damn fast as well.
We get our stuff shipped by a fulfillment house in Seattle, and it's actually the Penny Arcade fulfillment house, and those guys are awesome.
Yeah.
Brian and Nathan and Chip, I think, they might have hired more people, but I know those three people work there. And they're fantastic. When I arrive at home, remind me of this. There we go.
So, yeah, you should go definitely...
Oh, hey, we went live.
Do that. Well, that's exciting.
I signed up... Because I am logged in as Loading Ready Run here, I don't get told
when
we go live. I signed up for text message notifications.
Nice.
So I can know when we go live.
So go check out Card Kingdom. What else? What else were we going to talk about tonight?
I think Card Kingdom is cheating with their shipping. I just received some M19 singles that I assume I'm going to order.
Nice. I asked you the other day, you said that we can talk about the thing. Oh, nice. The thing at the thing next month?
Which thing? Oh, yeah. Hey.
Yeah.
Who's going to be at GP Portland?
The question will be, who's going to be at GP Portland after we tell you what we're going to tell you?
But just to say, we're going to be at GP Portland.
We are going to be at GP Portland.
It's a team sealed.
M15 team sealed.
Is the format. So myself and James and Jer are going to be a team.
Yep.
We're going down for Jer's birthday. We're going to play in the event. But on the Friday, we're going to do a panel.
Hooray!
We're going to do like a Q&A panel because the Ricky from the organizing team, Cascade Games, contacted us. It was like, hey, are you guys going to be there? Do you want to do a thing? And we're like, sure. So we're going to do a panel. It's like right before the...
Before the
how to do a sealed deck panel.
Yeah. I'm pretty excited. Cascade is absolutely who you want to be running your local GP.
They're really trying.
They're going all out with this.
Especially
thing.
After reading the really disappointing stuff about that other GP.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, GP, Cascade Games really seem like they're trying.
Like, they're trying to really push the GP to be more like a Magic convention.
Oh, it's just a panel, guys. It's not worth coming from the other coast.
Oh, yeah. But yeah, I'm pretty excited. So it's actually 4 days. Like, the GP in Portland is... Technically, it's Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Thursday?
Yeah.
What are they doing on Thursday?
Just side events. Kenji's streaming on Thursday.
I saw that. That's like an event that he's doing, right?
Yeah.
It's like a thing for the GP?
For the GP. They've invited him down. He's taken his computer, and he's going to set up shop in the main area somewhere.
I told him that we'd come and say hi.
Oh, yeah. I told him that we'd come say hi as well, for sure. And he's like, absolutely. And so he's going to set up shop and stream for, I think... like 9 hours on Thursday and then 9 hours on Friday.
Nice.
The idea, I think.
I thought he said he was just doing 18 hours.
I think, well, if assuming he can go, I don't know if he can go overnight. I mean, maybe he can. It depends on if they're allowed to be in the hall overnight like that. Portland, Oregon. Some places don't let you do that.
Guys, send me pictures of Graham and James. I'm making a thing.
Teamler will not be at GPLA in October. Yeah. I might be. I don't know yet. I'm thinking about going down to LA in October for the GP. But I don't know if that's going to work.
What format's that?
Standard. Blech. But I'd be going down to see a hockey game and playing some magic. Just because I really don't like the idea of only going to one GP a year.
Yeah.
And LA is the next closest, and I have a bunch of points that I could get down there for like $40.
Oh, sweet.
So I might make it work. I'll let you know. We'll see. We'll all be at PAX Prime in like a month and a bit. So that's exciting.
There's going to be a lot of us down at PAX Prime as usual, because it's the closest.
Yeah.
The closest place to here, so. Can you come to this? Probably not. What is it? Mile High Con. That sounds like it's Denver.
Colorado.
Yep. Yep.
Best science fiction and fantasy convention.
Neat. If they wanted us to be there, and wanted to fly us out.
That's over my birthday. Oh, that's the...
I don't like this website.
No, the website's not that good.
I don't feel like we fit into the oeuvre of this con, but oh god, I closed it. You can actually close it.
Interesting.
That's a weird design choice. Bold choice.
You can link Cascade. That's cool.
Yep. Are you from that area, Leobwin? I think we are hoping to come to PAX South.
Yeah.
I think like we're planning on basically making Tour de PAX kind of a thing.
Yeah, I could see Tour de PAX. Unfortunately, Australia doesn't factor in all that well with
I really wanted PAX. Really wanted to try and figure out if we could get there this year, and then they moved it to October.
Yeah, it's at the very end of October.
Which is super bad for us with Desert Bus.
Yeah.
So
because second. The problem is that you don't just go from Victoria to Australia for like a 3-day convention.
No.
You go to Victoria to Australia for like a 2-week vacation and you throw in the convention there as well. Like at the least you go for a 1 week and the convention, and going away for 1 week at the end of October is it's not the greatest timing. Next year maybe a little easier just because we might not have as much stuff on our plate. There's a lot for us to do, including Desert Bus.
Like, yeah, we have a lot of Kickstarter stuff we need to catch up on.
Yeah, there's a whole bunch of stuff that we need to do for the Kickstarter that we just do in general and throw on top of, Desert Bus. It's just, it's bad timing. So maybe 2015 we can get there. I would like to. Interesting.
I like that A169.
Yeah, that's
cool.
Yeah, cool.
With the tea. That's good. I'll put you guys up in my one-bedroom apartment. Sounds
nice.
Good.
There's 8 of us. Oh. No, PAX South is in San Antonio, actually.
Naxo, I will be at Gen Con, but in no official capacity. I'm just going to be at Gen Con. It's like, Loading Ready Run is not going to Gen Con, but I'll be there. Hello. I might have a Maximum Spoof shirt. Sweet. Yeah, we won round one. Oh, yeah. I should update the...
Oh, no, we're definitely doing Desert Bus in 2015. It's just we won't be doing all the other stuff. Well, we'll be doing a lot of stuff.
The only thing we're not doing is having a sketch every week, assuredly.
Yeah, and who knows what else. You would be
so
surprised.
Much beard.
You'd be surprised at how much that will free up some time, though.
Yeah, actually. Weirdly. We don't have a commander deck on this account. Koizum, hey Graham, I'm going to get some sleep. Are you starting your show earlier on time? That depends on how long this goes.
It should start. We got started right on time today. Generally, when we get started at 4:00, we're done by like 6:30.
Yeah.
It doesn't normally take that long for a Swiss to go on, so
Should we run a break? I want to go to the bathroom.
Yeah, we should.
Let's do that. We're going to run a quick commercial break, which will give me an opportunity to pee. And then we'll be right back. Actually, I'm going to update the stream title, too. Hang on. Update that stream title. Error, updating broadcast. Weird. Come on.
Excuse me.
There we go.
Very quickly, D&D Temple of the Lava Bears will be a thing starting next month.
Yeah. All right. Gonna go commercial break. Be right back. Beep boop.
Yo, let's open a pack.
We're gonna open a pack of M15.
Ah.
Crack it up.
Divine favor. Is this just first pick it?
Sure.
Okay, first pick?
No.
No.
Divine favor is no.
No. Do we first pick Nimbus of the Isles? Well, we certainly pick it over Divine Favor.
Yeah, so far. So far.
Nimbus of the Niles gets first pick.
So far.
So 3-3 for 5.
Yeah.
Flyer. Founder Street Denizen?
I think I'm still taking Nimbus.
I'm still taking the Nimbus. I think we have a new frontrunner, though.
Oh, yeah?
We have a Flesh to Dust.
Yeah.
Yeah, we take that over.
5 mana, instant speed removal.
Yeah.
It's what you gotta have.
Vine Weft?
No.
No. I don't even want to read this card. It's so bad. It's so bad. Will Forged Golem. Six colorless for a 4/4 with Convoke.
Still taking.
I still take the
Flesh
to
Dust.
This. Yeah. All right. Next up, Scrapyard Mongrel. 3 and a red for a 3/3. Good art. If you have an artifact, gets +2/+0 and has trample. I'm still taking the.
This guy seems fine.
He seems fine.
He's a 3/3 for 4. So
which
he's
is
a,
fine.
He's a
Hill Giant.
Hill Giant. Yeah.
But and I mean, if you have an artifact. Okay, he's a 5/3 with trample. That seems fine, right? Mm-hmm. Like, not a problem.
Still taking Flesh to Dust.
Yeah. No, just the light coming in. Selfless Cathar.
This guy's neat.
Yeah,
remember him? Remember him from Innistrad?
He was pretty good. Encrust? Is Encrust better than Flesh to Dust?
Like, pack one, pick one?
I
don't know.
I still think I'm taking... Flesh to Dust.
What do you guys think? Pack one, pick one. You're not in any colors yet. Encrust is cheaper, but it leaves the creature around. Flesh to Dust just kills it. And it's instant speed. That's an interesting question. What's the rest of the pack look like?
Goblin Rough Rider.
He's fine.
Yep, 2 and a red for 3/2.
He's a guy.
Yeah, he's a guy. Darksteel Citadel. If we have the Ensoul.
Not first picking that.
No. Restock? No. Restock is not very good.
Restock is also invisible.
Yeah.
There's so much green on this
so
card,
much green
it's just completely transparent.
Nice. Quickling?
Oh.
Quickling is pretty good.
I love Quickling.
Quickling is very good.
I still haven't really played with Quickling, but I just love the design.
Yeah.
I'll probably take Quickling.
I would
just
probably
like,
take Quickling.
Hope to get into that deck.
And then Avarice Amulet.
Avarice.
Avarice. See? A-V-A, and then rice.
It's pronounced avarice.
I'm pretty sure it's avarice. It seems pretty bad. I mean, it seems okay.
I think it's all right.
Yeah.
I think it's all right. I like the read on the limited resources review. They were like, if you can put it on something that they don't want to kill, and you can they don't want to waste removal on, and you can just sit there and like Howling Mind yourself every turn, then that's fine.
Yeah, that's fair. I still
but
don't think I'm first picking it over.
I love the design, though, in for what this is. You guys know what the Avarice Amulet is, right? I'm gonna hang on. Let me pull it up on the screen here. Oh, good. We did take. I was like, we're not still muted, are we?
Is that the? Yeah, that's the Penny Arcade card.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So. So the Avarice Amulet, designed by Penny Arcade. Is the Pac-Man watch. That there's a ongoing back and forth in the strip of them not mentioned there, of them killing each other for this Pac-Man watch. Like, repeatedly.
All right, okay. The Penny Arcade wiki is not very good.
Where is the view of the comic? There we go. Yes, bring Daddy the watch. Anyway, so it's a Pac-Man watch that you keep killing it each other for.
Yeah.
And it's got the crack in it, so it looks like Pac-Man. It's so good. Graham is wrong because I like James' pronunciation. Supergirl Alley, our day been good.
What?
How's you day been, Supergirl Alley?
Why are you so loud, Supergirl Alley? Jeez.
Please do not use all caps. But thank you. Okay, everyone, if you ever pack one, pick one, get Sliver Hive Lord, you have to force Slivers. I mean...
Oh, yeah. Well, you don't force Slivers, but you force five color.
Yeah, the problem with forcing Slivers is there's only five.
Four, five?
Well, there's the Mythic.
Yeah.
And then there's five others, and they're all uncommon.
Yeah, that's right.
So it's like...
No. You do not force Slivers in M15.
No. But I'll definitely force five color.
Yeah.
So. Hey, is the Team Loading Ready Run going to be at SDCC this weekend? No. Nope. We haven't. We would have had to have left by now.
Yeah,
it's Thursday.
It started today.
We would have had to be there by now. It takes us like a whole day to travel anywhere from here. We went to San Diego Comic Con.
2007.
Yeah, once in 2007. It was a lot of fun.
It is. I don't think San Diego Comic Con is really for us. You get kind of lost there if you aren't a movie studio.
We had a table in,
yeah,
Artist Alley. And there was people that came by and bought stuff, and that was fun.
Sure.
But if we went to Comic-Con again, we would be going as attendees. Like,
yeah.
I don't think it's
I would not go as Loading Ready. I don't think going as Loading Ready Run would be worth it.
Did you see, for example, this year, Scott Kurtz?
Yeah. He's...
Toonhound has a booth,
yeah,
but Scott's not going.
Yeah.
Because he's like... There's no Discovery on the show floor at Comic-Con anymore. No one actually... People want to come and buy the cute toys or whatever, but no one actually cares if I'm there.
No. Yeah, I mean, it's a fun con. It was a fun con to go to.
Yeah.
I don't really even have that much of a desire to go back. The only way I would go back, and I mean, this will sound douchey, but is if I had some sort of VIP privileges, because... there's no way I'm waiting in those lines. I don't even really want to like walk around the show floor. There's just too many people.
It's
like
the biggest show floor I've ever seen.
Yeah,
that place was too big.
It was huge when we went there, and that was in 2007, and it's only gotten bigger. And it's just like no.
Like PAX East is massive.
Yeah,
and Comic-Con absolutely
I don't even
dwarfs
like. And
PAX
here's
East.
And here's more douchey for you. I don't even like being on the show floor at PAX. That's why I love having VIP badges, because we get to go in an hour early on the Friday and check it out. And then we're done. It's like, all right, I've seen the show floor. No more.
Hey, congratulations. Your PAX Prime panel has been approved.
Nice.
Your PAX Prime panel of Loading Ready Run Comedy Foundry. I forgot I called it that. Tentatively scheduled for Sunday at 4 p.m.
That's a good time.
That's a good time.
Yeah, like, it's not in the way of concerts, which it was for a couple years when we first started getting panels. It's not on the Monday, so everybody's going to be tired.
Because don't forget, it's four days.
It's 4 days. Fuck. Yeah, no, that looks good. Panelists include... Oh, what did they do wrong?
Nothing, they didn't do anything wrong.
Oh.
This is the description. The team behind PATV's Strip Search and Checkpoint, the Escapists Unskippable and Feed Dump, and the Desert Bus for Hope fundraiser will show you funny things and answer all of your questions. All of them. Time/interest permitting. I wrote that. Panelists include Graham Stark, producer, Loading Ready Run. Kathleen DeVere, writer, Loading Ready Run. James Turner, fixer, Loading Ready Run.
Nice.
Cameron Lauder, actor, Loading Ready Run. Brendan Beach Derry, actor, Loading Ready Run. Alex Stacey, chicken man, Loading Ready Run. I forgot. I think that was me. I must have... Presumably, Cahill was like, I need a panel description tonight. And I was like, okay. Chicken man. Also, I didn't know if Jer was going to be there or not. So he's not listed on the panel.
But Jer is coming.
Jer will be there. And Matt's coming too? He should be, right?
I would assume so.
All right. We'll pretend that they're on the list as well.
They'll be on the list. They'll be there. So if you're coming, they will be there.
Yeah.
That's good. I'm excited.
Will Beach be wearing his con pants? Probably.
God, I hope not.
Probably. I don't think you can stop him.
We could probably stop him. We could be like, hey, we're getting you a badge. If you want to be here representing Loading Ready Run, you will dress like a normal human being.
It was so funny.
At least for our panel, damn it, all right?
It was so funny in Detroit.
Because it wasn't that big of a con?
It was, like, not that big of a con, but it's, like, not that many attendees knew who we were.
Right.
Actually, there was, there were several people who did, but it's, like, you got, like, me, and I'm just dressed normally, and you've got Cam and Kathleen, who tend to dress very well, or at least they take a lot of time to make sure that they have some sort of style about them. And then Beej in his giant, like, giant Canada pants and his, like, gi and the hat and everything. It's just like, who are you?
Yeah. No, I say we pull the, you're here representing Loading Ready Run.
He can do whatever he wants. I don't know. Dark Lord Keiko, Matt does collect angels, as far as I'm aware.
I don't know if he still does.
All right,
I
mean, round two. Let's play first.
He wouldn't say no.
All right, this is the deck we're playing.
Oh, come on, land. Jesus.
Come on.
We can't keep this.
No, we can't.
That sucks. This is possibly worse. I mean, we can play a bodyguard.
This is worse. This is much worse.
Yeah.
Dang it. We probably should have just kept it and just hoped the first hand. We had slide.
But we only had one land, and ugh.
What would be the best loading time to see Beej's stuff in? This is another mulligan, right?
He didn't wear that to Lurkon, did he?
Oh, yeah, he did.
Yeah, he was dressed in that.
For sure
Lurkon.
He was.
Yeah.
We're going to five, right?
Yeah, okay. There we go.
What the?
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, you'll probably just want to hang up on that.
Hello? Hello?
Yeah, telemarketer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I can't talk right now. I'm sorry. Thank you.
Tip for you. If a 1-800 number calls you, and you answer and you say hello, and there's silence for about 2 seconds... I promise you it's a telemarketer.
Yeah.
That's how that works.
Hell with it. I'm going to go cave so we can maybe play the...
protect ourselves for
maybe
a little
play
bit.
The wall next turn.
Yeah, I'm okay with that.
It was a call from Rogers, but it wasn't about my bill because I had just paid my bill.
No,
so.
It'll be the, how's your experience going?
Fine.
What would you like to do? Can we interest you in any sort of... changings to your thing. No, go away. Leave me alone.
My experience has been fine. Please leave me alone.
Is the new iPhone out yet? Jesus. Mm-hmm. I'm sick and tired of this piece of crap.
Whoa! Pile driver?
That's cool.
Alright. So what do you say we just strip mine one of those?
Probably. Seems like a good plan.
We can even play
the elite and strip mine something. Go for it.
All right.
Hello, you're talking to the internet. Look, I have 1,000 people watching me on the internet right now. I need to go.
I need to leave.
Yeah, I'm busy.
Damn it! Mr. Kid MTG, that's not really a fair question. Magic or Loading Ready Run?
Choose one, Graham? Wow. I mean, you choose Loading Ready Run. It's kind of your job.
Yep. like I said, it's not really a competition.
Yeah. I mean, it would suck, but...
I'm going to cycle.
Yep. Sure do need to draw stuff. Playable things.
Neat.
Sure.
Maybe we'll be able to play that next turn. I can force this trade. But I can block this, so I don't really care.
Mm-hmm.
Eh, just pass. Oh, there we go. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Here's Beej. Wait. Wait. You link to this. He's on here. He's in here somewhere. There's a picture. That's the wrong link. Here we go. Let's try this one. All right. Yep, that's him.
I mean, that's basically what he wears.
Those pants covered in Canadian flags. Is this my second main? Oh. Thought I F6'd. Whoops. Okay, I take one.
Ow.
Uh-oh. Mm. Well, we found the goblin deck. Matron looking for... Whoop! War Chief!
Jeez.
Uh-oh. Balls. I really wanted to play the Faithful this turn. We can only even play this if we cycle into an untapped plains.
Wait, what? What was that?
The only way that we can... I was just saying, we can either play the trooper,
yeah,
or we can cycle and hope we hit a plains and play the trooper, but that also seems bad. Tony213, it's just taken us a while to get a handle on all the footage. We've gotten all the, like, we have all the footage from the videographer, and we have all the footage from Dark Morford that he sent us. And it just, there's been a lot of stuff. We got it like a week before my wedding, so I had some stuff to do. So we have a lot of work going on right now. But we will get that footage online for you. Just play the land, you're probably right. Let's just play it.
Yep.
All right. Play you, trooper. Pass. Yep. Bodyguard. Interesting. So he can't even play the War Chief, because we took him off double red. All right, so Pile Driver is now a 3-2. Well, I'm going to try and block with the wall. And he didn't give this shadow, so I could trade for it.
Yeah, I think you just do that.
Yeah. Or trade for the goblin, if that's more relevant. But
no, it's not.
I mean, it makes this thing huge, but all right, let's try it. I guess Kindle sort of gets us. All right, so he's going to be going off with Pile Driver next turn.
Ugh. Well, we can gain 4 life.
I think we just play this.
Yep.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Trooper can't block, so Trooper's going to attack. Gotta go. Gonna watch more Loading Ready Run.
Alright.
Sounds good to me, Mr. Mr. Kid MTG. You have good taste.
And the echo. So that's going to be a 5-2.
If he attacks with the other goblins, but we can actually like.
Yeah,
we can actually profitably block other goblins.
Yeah. Well, he's doing it.
Okay. I agree, Nirvana. All right, so that thing's so. I guess we take 5 from that.
Yep.
But we're
taking 6 total here. That seems kind of bad, but that's fine.
Get to block other stuff. We get to eat the Goblin Patrol, which he spent his red mana this turn echoing. Okay. I guess we get to eat the bodyguard then.
Oh, he saved his goblin?
That seems fine. Alright. Well, we only take 5 then. Come on, slide. Dang. Well, I guess we play it. Should we cycle?
Probably. We need
probably to just cycle. Probably shouldn't have played that land. Oh, well. Ooh. Well, that's pretty much just going to kill this Pile Driver, right?
Do we do it right? Yeah, it's a sorcery, right? I forgot about that. Yes.
Bye-bye. Was that all your aggression? Bummer.
Do either of you intend to participate in the near endless stream of MTG drafts events at PAX Prime? I mean, it's tricky to get in too much Magic at Prime. We're kind of busy.
Prime is so busy for us.
It would be nice to get in, like, a draft.
Yeah.
And we try to generally, like, set aside some time on, like, a day to play Magic with everybody. And I don't think this year will be any different.
Come on, whiff. Oh, he not only did he not whiff, he hit Goblin Goon. Ugh. Filth beats. What happens to the other cards? They go to the bottom. All right, so he misses. Well, that hurts, he says.
Yeah, because now he's... Yeah.
So those go away. So he hit the Goon, which is going to be able to attack, but he missed out on all his double reds. Ugh. But we sure didn't.
Yeah, I mean, the early strip mine is doing work.
Yeah. Having him... Presumably he's got, like, a Goblin General in hand, too.
Yep.
Don't do it.
And he just pitched. Yeah, so there's a Goon.
Oh, boy. So he gets to start browning us with this thing pretty soon. Ugh. Gas.
Well, that's a card.
Not bad. Do I play this?
No.
Okay. What's our deck end up drafting? We are draft. It is a red white astral slide deck that only
crap. Okay, we lose.
Only has one astral slide.
We're so dead.
Like, we have to take six out this goon, don't we? We could chump with the Gustcloak Harrier. Harrier blocks Goon for a turn. What'll turn Goon off? No, it'll just make Goon worse. Ooh, that makes Goon not able to attack.
Yeah. Alright, so attack with Trooper. No, we're not scooping here.
Nope.
Not quite dead. Not quite. And also, we play this Chief, and now Goon is offline.
Goon can only attack or block if our opponent controls more creatures. And now we are 5 creatures to 7 creatures. So, that's something. Later, Drunk Gary. I hope it works out for you. No!
Oh, crap.
Now we're even on creatures again. Probably going to be the Harrier.
That would be the card I would blow up.
Because that blocks Bassandra. Well, chumps Bassandra.
Yep.
Yep. What do we mull to this game? 5?
Yeah, I think so.
I think we're doing okay on a mull to 5. Yep. Well, at least he's not leaving mana up for Bassandra activated ability.
Yeah.
Little late. That doesn't actually help us at all. I don't think.
He's a 10. We really need to.
Like, is there any way that that's good for us?
If we draw Fire Blast next turn, it's pretty good.
Is it?
Yeah, because then we can sacrifice 2 mountains to cast Fire Blast, kill Bassandra, and then we can chump for a little bit.
But we can't cast Fire Blast if we play Armageddon. Yeah, it would have helped 4 turns ago when we were ahead on board.
Yeah. Keeping him off double red doesn't...
It doesn't actually help, because he's already ahead on board here.
Yeah, like, we need to deal with that flyer. Like, we're just dead to that flyer in 2 turns. And if he has a burn spell, we're just dead next turn. Like, I don't think we'd do it.
It's terrible for you. Do it anyway.
No, it's not. Yeah, I mean, it is terrible, so...
It's pretty bad for
us.
It's
really bad, so I don't think we'd do it. Yeah. Like, and we don't need to show it to him, so...
Yeah. Are we... I don't think we're dead here. Oh.
Oh, now we can't.
Okay,
so... Okay, now we're dead.
So we're dead.
All right. Moving on.
Well, I guess Armageddon would have made it so he wasn't able to cast that.
Ooh, he's nice. Oh, nope. Never mind. There it goes. Nice and exacties. That's fine. Moving on.
At least we're being honest about why we want to do it. Yeah, no, that's fair.
No. Not anywhere near close.
That would protect us from Falter, wouldn't it? Would it? No, because they're not being targeted.
It's not being targeted, yeah.
All right.
No, I think we just keep going.
Mm-hmm. Nah. This is the only thing that kills Bessandra right now.
Yeah, if you want to run the aftershock.
Over what, though?
The Elite?
Yeah.
The Elite's really not that great, I don't think.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah.
But we didn't have Fire Blast, so.
No, I said we needed to draw it, but yeah.
You don't want to. We don't want to play Armageddon against his deck. Just because all his stuff is tiny anyway. I second cutting Geddon.
All right, go for it.
Ooh, key smoky.
No drinks off.
His deck is quite aggro. Yes, let's play first. Okay.
Yeah, it's not bad.
It's fine. It's like not exciting, but...
Maybe it's too slow. Slick, slick, man. I think that's what that is.
Slick Slickman has just subscribed.
Woo!
You know what? I'm just going to cycle this step.
Yep, do it. Thank you for subscribing, Slick Slickman.
Slick Slickman!
Sub hype! Spot the dog him. Spot him.
Welcome to the channel, Slick Slickman. Is that a resub? I recognize the name. I could be wrong.
Ooh. I find it's hard to call resubs just because people sub... All throughout.
Yeah. I'm just going to play the step now.
Yeah.
Because I just want to hit. I want to make sure we hit 4 mana. And just go. Just chief, faithful. Oh, turn 2 pile driver both times.
What a jerk. All right. Here we are. Excuse me.
Just a resub, accidentally let it slip. Well, thank you anyway.
Hooray, welcome back.
One dommage.
Graham James, have you ever considered Geek Good? No, never. Hasn't ever crossed my mind.
Should we cycle anything here just to draw a card?
Or
keep this?
I could see cycling and drawing a card here.
All right.
Maybe that's bad. Who knows?
Oh, not quite. All right. Haha! It is I who have the goblins.
Okay, now we really want to draw Slide. I want to just slide Chief, like both Chiefs.
No!
Oh, you son of a bitch!
you chump. You absolute chungus. I will trade you both goblins for your pile driver, the way.
All day, every day. Oh, you son of a bitch.
That's okay. We have another one.
Yeah.
We have another.
Of course, that thing's attacking is a 6-2 next, 7-2 next turn.
That's okay. It still trades with...
Yeah, 2. Yeah, that's true.
I wish I could have kept up Spark Spray there. Steal my goblins.
Our opponent's like, why you steal my goblins?
I like this board state right now.
Yep.
This is the definition of a mirror match for now. Man, you suck.
You big pooper. Come on, Fire Blast.
Get gobbled.
I'm not going to cycle here.
No.
All right. I guess I play Faithful? I could actually just cast this guy. I think I just play Faithful.
316 is pretty good here, actually.
Yeah, so does gaining 4 life and keeping up Spark Spray.
Yeah.
Cycling will help you draw to Fire Blast. That's true. So maybe we should get cycling. Yeah, we need to start aggro cycling into our into our business. Hey, Bassandra.
Cycle that step.
You
probably cycle the spark spray. One damage is probably not going to do much here.
Yeah.
Stoke champion is not really what we want there.
Not super good, no.
Although I guess we can.
He's gonna make something attack.
Yep.
Probably this. We can make that not happen once. Oh, does that work?
What?
If we... Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, if we'd killed a token, Goon wouldn't be active. But we'll just play a guy here. In fact, we'll play two guys here.
Getting ready, wrecked.
Oh, okay. That's fine. Goon, still not active. Just barely.
And dead.
No, it's... Oh, if they're tied, it still is not active. All right, well, still. Still.
Not hurting for red this game.
No. He's got 6 creatures. We have 7 creatures. Okay, so he actually needs more, so a tie doesn't even work.
Yeah.
Okay. Guess I've been thinking. Ooh. Well, all right, that's going to be really,
that's really bad.
Really bad next turn. Yep. Yep.
Yeah, I think we're just dead.
We're probably dead.
He won game one. That doesn't even do anything, really. Keep him off double white, but I don't think that matters.
Do we just cast this?
Yeah.
All right. Sure. We're very, very not favored to win this game.
Yeah. I'd say 2% right now.
Yeah.
Really? He's only making one attack? Oh, there we go. pudding ready scoop.
And dance. That's actually a really good point. Is he going to head on creatures now? We're going to six here?
Yep.
Shoot. Yeah, you're right. Actually, we should have... Why didn't I attack with the trooper? Oops. Eh, whatever.
Oh, okay, we're dead.
Are we?
Yep.
I think so. Okay.
He's gonna hit us for two.
Oh, yeah.
4, 6, 8, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, like 27, I think. If I did that math right. Very quickly.
Pile driver is at 12-3.
We go from 15 to minus 17. Nope, 32.
I just said nice.
Jesus. All right, that was disgusting. That's actually probably one of the best goblin decks I've seen in a while.
Yeah.
That was a
it's
very...
It's rare you get pile driver.
Yeah, pile driver plus a chief and a goon and a general. Yeah. That's bad.
All right. Fair enough. Fair enough.
All right.
Our opponent said pretty lucky draws there, which is fair.
All right. Well,
please don't run to time. So long.
Yeah.
You are a bloody red smear on the battlefield. It's true. It is true.
One already had the bye, so that could speed it up. Only three games.
Oh, sweet.
Hmm.
Well, all the PAX Prime panels are being approved.
Yeah.
So the improv initiative is back.
Nice.
With who's in it this year? Dan, myself, Greg, Beege, and Ian.
Nice.
So we're doing the improv initiative again, so that'll be good. And the late night dub fight. Back on Sunday.
Nice.
So sweet. They've renamed all the theaters. Late Night Dub Fight is Sunday night at 9 in the Sandworm Theater. And Improv Initiative is Saturday night at 8:30 in the Sphinx Theater.
Which is, I believe, where our was.
So sweet.
What is that?
That's the Lurcraft is now following me on Twitter.
Oh. Twitter follows. So that's
who runs that? Is that Does Mamo run the Twitter account, too?
I believe so, yeah. I should start using mail again. It looks okay again now.
Do you not use mail?
I use Gmail.
Huh.
The schedule is not out, no. Just the panels have been...
The panelists have started to receive confirmation that their things are happening.
Yeah.
So... All the theaters now start with the same letter as the venue they're in. Oh, yeah. Okay, so Sphinx will be at the Sheridan.
Yeah.
And Sandworm will be at the
Sheridan. Yeah.
Oh! That's smart.
Yeah, that's what they did with...
Yeah, at East.
At East they did...
ABC?
Didn't they do... Did they do ABC? Yeah, I think they went ABC because... And they split it into quadrants.
Oh, the BCEC had underwater animals for level 0, ground animals for level 1, and flying animals for level 2.
Oh, that's right.
Smart. Yeah. So S Sheridan, W for WSCC, and H for Hyatt.
Yeah.
Does it say this anywhere on the map or in the book, Dostro? Because that's cute.
I assume it will.
But they need to tell people that.
No, I assume they will.
Graham, have you and Kathleen ever considered making Twitters with your cats? We've joked about it.
Twitter accounts for your cats?
I think...
I'd probably have to stop being your friend if you did that.
I think two of our cats might have Facebook pages. You can do, like, Facebook pets or whatever, but... It's like our current cat and the one that passed away, but I don't believe Baxter has one.
He's too cool for social media.
Yeah. I post vines of him a lot. So there's that. Now, whoop.
We should run a shame commercial.
Eh? We should run a shame commercial. Let's do that. Mm-hmm. We'll be back in a moment.
Enjoy our shame.
Beep.
Yep. Waiting for round three, Yos.
Still waiting for round three. I like the scrolling text.
Yeah, that's a good idea. That way people know what's going on.
We're in a Swiss roasted gravy, so there's still one more round.
Yeah.
The stupid...
We don't...
The sunlight.
Yeah, that's why we need to get a new blind. I might just... Yeah, probably order
see one. What you can steal from work.
I don't know if there's anything, like, easily steal. The problem with blinds is that they're made to fit.
Yeah.
I could probably steal and cut something down.
Like some vertical, like some, like, normal Venetian blinds?
I'd rather not Venetians because they'll blow in the winds. Yeah. I'd rather, like, either roller shade or...
Roller shade would be
something
good.
Something a little fancier. Yeah. I'm sure that I can probably cut down something.
Because it can come all the way down.
Yeah, to the...
To just above the, yeah. The air conditioner thing.
Yep.
Guys, I'm going to mute you so I can watch your season 10. Go for it!
All of it?
Just arrived. What is the deck? Well, I'll show you the deck, actually, rather than tell you about it. It is a Vintage Masters Astral Slide deck, and it looks like this. I say it's an Astral Slide deck because it has...
It has one copy of
Astral Slide. And the following Enter the Battlefield creatures. It's got two Beetleback Chiefs, two Taro's Faithfuls, mostly that. It's also got a Solitary Trooper for just random cycling value, and it's got for Fun Police, it's got a Strip Mine and an Armageddon, but it's got two Forgotten Caves, four Secluded Steps, so that's six cyclers, seven, eight, nine, 10 cards that cycle. Round one, game one, we went absolutely ham with Astral Slide. It was goofy. Round one was very, very good. Round two, less so. We went up against the nuts goblin deck. Tika 12.
Woo!
Tika 12. Just subscribed.
Hooray!
Tika 12. Thank you for subscribing.
Okay. I'm selling a lens on Use Victoria.
One sec. Amethyst, that was part of it. The Kickstarter was for Season 11 and the streaming.
Yeah, the stream. Yeah, this was part of Season 11.
It was indeed. But we're going to keep doing it.
Yeah, we'll probably keep doing
cause
it.
Because
it's fun.
It's fun for all of us, and it's actually, it's also, like, working really well. It's, we all like having the excuse to play games, so. What were you saying, James?
So
actually, wait, I want to reset the record.
Selling a lens online used.
Okay.
It is a 17-50 2.8. It's a nice lens.
Okay.
I just don't need it anymore, so I want to sell it. And I got a response. And look, I mean... Photography, it's a little confusing, there's lots of numbers, but this question is not, just think about it for 1 second. I'm interested, but I'm also considering an 11-15 millimeter lens. I'm curious if they are similar. By the very nature of those numbers, you should be able to tell that they are not. They're not similar in any way.
11-15?
11-15 is a wide angle lens.
Yeah.
17-50 is not a wide angle lens. It's like a mid-range zoom, if anything. Dear God. I'll respond to you later.
Dear Dr. Graham, are you aware that some members of the community are shipping girls from the pair? Alright. I think we'd imagine them as roommates, but go for it. Why not?
Yeah, I assume they were. Tamron. It is a Tamron lens, Nikon mount.
Amethyst. Yeah, I think I'll be playing more Human Revolution tonight.
Yes, exactly. Plummeted Sloth.
Gotta get that,
What are you gonna play?
Gotta get that Adam Jensen value. More Deus Ex Human Revolution.
Ah, okay.
I've been really enjoying it. It's a fun game. What am I doing in the game right now? Did I finish the police station? I think I finished the police station last time. Maybe I'm wrong.
I ship the underwear and the floor from that video. Nice.
Bro.
Asthanius? I have no idea.
I hope not. He makes us all look bad.
Right?
Like, as in, he's better looking than all of us. And also, isn't he, like, kind of an actor of some sort?
Yeah, but...
So he's good looking and a better than actor than all of us?
Yeah.
This is bullshit.
But maybe we need that in certain situations. And he was really keen.
Yeah. Like he was awesome.
He assimilated perfectly into our production style, which is sort of haphazard.
I admire that they've put in advice back to you, Marshall, in Lurbot.
That is good.
I like that. You had just finished the police station.
Okay, sweet.
Come on, end of round, let's go. What have they changed / improved the V4 client on Mitgo since you started using it? A lot of stuff. I mean,
yeah.
It would be...
We've been using it for over a year.
It would be incredibly short-sighted for somebody to say that it hasn't improved over the course of its open beta. Like, it absolutely has.
Yeah.
For some people, it hasn't improved enough, and that's fine, but whatever. But it is getting better.
I'm excited now that because they've switched over entirely to version 4, everyone from the version 3 team can now stop supporting version 3.
Yeah.
So they have more people on it now. Whether or not stuff happens quickly enough, who knows? But at least there's that.
So, I see. I mean, we'll see. I think the next couple months are going to be pretty important for...
I like the changes they've made to the making the life total nice and big.
Yeah.
Immoral ethicist. Sorry. Immoral ethicist. No, I haven't got to the first boss yet, but I am excited to see how it goes in the director's cut.
Why not play Hearthstone between rounds?
Dear Dr. Graham, I'm going to make a blue-black zombie deck on Magic Online. I have no idea what to actually include. Would you be willing to offer advice? I mean, for what format?
Blue-black zombie deck? Grimgrin. That's all you need.
Is there a version 5 beta coming? Probably not.
We're not going to start that just because we're, like, theoretically pretty close to the end of the round.
Sorry, David. I also don't have the Stow, I don't think. I don't think I have the right avatars for that. Do I?
Yeah, trading, from what I understand. I don't do a lot of trading, but from what I understand, it's not the greatest. But, I mean, that's something that needed to be fixed in...
Oh, no, I do.
...version 3. The marketplace on Magic is not good.
I like that they've had it. They've made it so that trades now open in their own window.
Yeah, that's definitely better.
I dig that. Yeah, I thought that was good, Nirvana. I don't think that, like, there's absolutely. It's insane to think that the people who make Magic Online do not listen to the feedback, whether or not they are able to act on the feedback.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
When maybe they should be is another thing entirely. But the idea that they are not listening is bonkers. Crack a pack. All right. Let's do that. This pack has Jace on the front.
Oh boy.
Wall of Fire. Yes or no?
No. Well, I mean, yes, because it's the first card I've seen.
Midnight Guard.
That takes over Wall of Fire. Easy.
Void Snare.
Ooh. I still think I want the Midnight Guard.
Oh, Void Snare's a sorcery?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, it's not just an unsummon. I don't know why you didn't just print unsummon, but that's fine.
Witch is Familiar.
Still a Midnight Guard. Although that's okay.
They're both 2/3s for 3.
Yeah.
But Witch is Familiar does literal nothing.
Yeah.
And Midnight Guard has a
very
possible
relevant
ability.
Yeah.
Shaman of Spring, with the crazy art.
This is the draw card one?
Yeah, it's the bigger Elvish Visionary.
Yeah, I'm probably putting this over Midnight Guard right now.
It's like a 4-mana 2/2, but you get a card.
You draw a card off it? I think I'm taking that over Midnight Guard. I also just seem to... I kind of like green in M15 so far from what I've seen and watched being played and played myself. So I'm probably leaning more towards the Shaman.
I super dig the new card frame and font, by the way.
Yep. I don't even really notice it, to be honest.
I actually really like it. Sanctified Charge.
Good card.
Good card.
Probably not first picking it, though.
No. For those who are unaware, Sanctified Charge, 5 mana, 4 and a white. Instant. Creatures you control get +2/+1, which is already good. White creatures you control also get first strike.
Briars of Fox is wondering if we've gotten his letter packs yet.
Yes.
Oh,
we have. They're sitting with your note on the Tap Concede table.
Nice. What packs did we get?
It's a pack of Homelands and a pack of M15.
Nice.
And the idea is to open them both.
Nice.
There's a note associated with it.
Sweet. All right, what's next?
Will Forged Golem.
Eh, whatever. Not first picking.
Chrono Stutter. I have a question about Chrono Stutter.
Uh-huh.
Is putting the card one draw step away worth the extra 2 mana? Because I don't actually think it is.
I mean...
I prefer Griptide.
I prefer Griptide, but I'm playing this card.
Yeah, but the thing is, it's like, it's more expensive because you put it deeper. I don't think that is actually a good enough thing.
Yeah, no, I don't think so.
Like, the nice thing about Griptide is you know exactly what they're going to draw. Whereas this, you know they'll draw in a turn, but you'll still... They still get another draw step. And... That's not why.
No, it's
putting it away is not why you like is not why Griptide is good.
No,
it's like setting them back the cost of that creature. It's like super bouncing it.
Well, yeah,
I mean, one or two down in the deck doesn't matter. Like I wouldn't even care if this was 3 cards down from the top.
No, I don't think that matters. I mean, I'm still playing it because it's the Griptide of the deck or of the format.
So but expensive.
It's pretty expensive.
Yeah. Borderland Marauder.
Sure.
That seems good.
Not first pickable. Or not first picking here.
Oresco Swiftclaw. This is much worse in this format than it was in in full draft JBT.
We lost round 2.
Venom Sliver.
No.
This one? Really?
I still like the other cards better, I think. But
this... Which one? Shaman of Spring?
I think. I mean...
This is the only Sliver that I'm totally fine running by itself. The white one I probably also would... But this one, it's a 1/1 death touch for 2.
Yeah? Yeah.
I mean, it's no, like...
I still don't...
Typhoid Rats is in the set, and that's a 1/1 death touch for 1.
Yeah.
But... Emerald Mimo, I have not. Anyway, I think Venom Sliver is probably the sliver that works the best on its own.
That's fair. I still don't know if I first pick it over.
Cone of Flam!
I'd probably pick that.
That's the first pick now.
Yeah, that card is insane.
Cone of Flam. Ooh, what about Necrogen? What about Necrogen Scudder?
What's that one again?
It's a 3/3 flyer for 3.
And you lose 3 life?
You lose 3 life?
Yeah, that's pretty crazy aggressive.
Ugh. Yeah, see, Mr. Flip is right. If Chrono Stutter cost 4, it would be just barely better than Griptide.
Yeah.
And the difference is marginal.
Yeah. All right.
I don't think it is significantly better than Griptide if it costs 4. I think it's barely a difference, and I still think Griptide is better.
I still think I'm taking Cone of Flame.
Oh, I know what I'm first picking. Polymorphist's Jest.
Yeah, that card's pretty.
This is so cool.
It's pretty good.
So Polymorphist's Jest, it's a mass turn to frog. It's 1 blue until instant until end of turn. Each creature target player controls, so it gets around hexproof, loses all abilities and becomes a blue frog with base power toughness 1/1.
Yeah,
so they're like, I attack with all my guys, and you're like, all right, I make a bunch of blocks. Also, all your guys are 1/1s that do nothing, so they all die.
Pretty good trick.
Pretty good trick.
We're gonna go to time. I blame you for this. This is the worst.
Time is now an hour.
Time is an hour.
Time is not 50 minutes.
Ah, oh, crap.
Only for a little longer.
Yeah.
Only till like what? Mid-August.
Mid-August. Yeah.
Yeah. For those who are unaware of what we're talking about, they increased the round time from 25 minutes aside to 30 minutes aside to let people get used to the beta. So if everything, if every round goes fully to time and everyone uses all of their sideboarding, a round could take an hour and 5 minutes. They're 1-1 frogs. Jest won me a bunch of games at FNM last week, yeah. We did lose to the Goblin deck, it's true. Well, I don't like the extended round times because I don't need the round time, but other people do. Featherweight made a stuffed spoopifer. He's very squat, but he's adorable.
He's so cute. He's so spoopy.
Hey, guys.
Do you think Venom Sliver is better than Belligerent Sliver? 2-2 can't be blocked except by two or more creatures. I do. I absolutely think Venom Sliver's better. Belligerent Sliver's fine. He's a gray ogre that has madcap skills, I guess, which is fine. But I think the death touch is way more relevant, especially in like a green-black deck where you can just sit there and block with him. Or hold things back, rather.
Yeah.
Doop doop doop. Doop a doop a doop a doop a doop boo.
Rune Club Bear is best card in the set.
What's this stolen joke?
That's the spoopifer.
Oh, that's the spoop. Yeah.
Actually, wait. Doo 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 doo. Look at him.
So adorable.
What's been up here recently? There's been some good stuff lately, I think. That's from Camstream.
Nice.
I really enjoyed it. Cam spent several minutes talking to one of his XCOM squad, being like, okay, if you kill this sectoid, I will let you have a kitten. It's against regulations.
Nice.
Whatever. Just please. Make this shot. And he did.
Nice.
Okay, how do you make that emote work?
What?
The bearded dragon. Because we are using better Twitch. What do you need to have installed to make the bearded dragon emote work? There it is. It's working over here.
Oh, yeah. Weird. Yeah, I don't know why it doesn't work.
I do like this one. I love the drawing. I love Cam.
Nice. Nice.
Big dead thug.
And yeah, I see that. Nice. Sweet.
Bartholomew, exactly.
Come on. Magic. Yay. Oh.
All right.
Wow, that was perfect timing.
That worked well.
Somehow we get the round three bye.
Nope. Thank goodness.
That would be pretty unusual if we did.
I'd be super annoyed.
I'd be super worried about the client.
Yeah.
They give the one in one a buy, but not the other two.
Yes. Yes.
Yep.
All right. Keep it. So we don't cycle these land, basically?
No, because we want to be able to cast our chief.
Is this the cool Canadian bros? James, we're the cool Canadian bros.
I appreciate it. I'm excited to be a bro. Click the gear, click BTT settings, enable emotes, but make sure it's BTT emotes and not monkey faces.
All right.
Interesting.
I do love that bearded dragon. Okay, sweet. Now we can cycle.
Yep.
Hell with it.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, baby. Oh, baby. Whatever. We got plenty of good four drops coming up. Oh, don't be Storm. I don't think this hand can race Storm. Oh, okay. Ha! Ha ha!
Ooh. Do that.
Really?
I think so.
And just
hit the island? I think we do. That slows him way down. And he's got no pressure on us. And then next turn we can start rolling up chiefs?
Yeah, you're probably right.
I think. I don't know. That's just me wanting to be kind of a dick with strip mine, though. So, I don't know if that's actually the right play. I think we do.
I mean... Oh, that's a much cooler monkey face. Which one's that? Oh, those are the turbo faces.
Yeah.
All right. Everyone else says there's no fun allowed, so...
Get out.
Get out, island. Get out. Damn it.
Oh, God.
Uh-oh. All right. You can attack if you want. All right, sweet.
So, possibly Madness? Is there a blue-black Madness deck? It's more of a...
I don't think so. He did not chat. He was waiting to respond. I mean, he chatted at the beginning. Whoa, Kezzerdrix. Kezzerdrix is a pretty good blocker for our guys.
Attack and just get rid of the Kezzerdrix?
It's got first strike. Yeah. So if we do that to the Psychotog...
I mean, he can discard.
He discards... Well, he discards... Oh, just one card. All right. That doesn't work. All right. Let's play the Faithful.
Yeah.
Because then we can... If we get another Plains, then we can Screech. Mm-hmm. Yeah, apparently Black-Blue Beats is just a deck. Dear Dr. Chat and Literary Run, who made Percival? No one that I know of made him. We bought him from a booth. He's mass-produced. We bought him from a booth in Detroit. And he's adorable.
We are playing Vintage Masters.
Mango Man, we are playing.
Mango Man.
Vintage Masters. Oh, it's true, we can play and cycle. Gush. Wow. Oh, just hard cast. I thought he was bouncing his islands for that. Nope. Just hard casting the Gush. All right. Mango Man, you do keep what you pull. Yeah, okay.
That was a weird attack.
So if we...
I feel like we want to get the chief out, or the Screech, but
we can't.
We can cycle, right? So it just makes it kind of awkward.
Cam named him. We were trying to name him something British, and so Cam named him Percy. He prefers Percival. Oh, well, thank you, Mega Man. Welcome to the channel. I don't know what to do here. Like, I kind of just want to play the other Beetle back.
Yeah, that's fine.
Get more blockers. Pretend we have swords. I don't know.
I mean, we actually kind of want to cast Templar. But,
Yeah. Just because he blocks Kezzerdrix?
Yep.
Yeah.
So maybe next turn we
draw... Unspoken Kibbles, no. We did not draft goblins. These are the only goblins in the deck. We drafted Slide. This is actually a super fun Astral Slide deck that just doesn't have...
That only has one... Oh, Morphling. Oh, God. That's good.
So we lose? Wait. Oh, he's got one mana up. He can make it a 2/4, and yeah. Then we can't chain lightning.
I mean, that's how you play Morphling, though, right? You keep it up so you can protect it. Well,
we get to play Battle Screech.
And
Yeah, do it. File Screech and get more Screeches. TGAP 37, after this draft, we will be Go-Go Gadget Famine. No. Please don't have famine. no more drafting after this, but we'll be switching shows to my show, and I'm playing Deus Ex Human Revolution right now. So,
God, that card's good.
We can't kill anything.
Nope.
We can kill this.
Yeah, it doesn't even matter though, because we can just block it all day. And you can block Kestertricks too.
We're not in a good spot. Let's put it that way.
Yeah, pulling Armageddon would be pretty freaking good now.
Ah, okay. So he's killing our wall.
Okay.
So we can't block the mercenary anymore. So presumably he's going to jump the morphling and just crush in with mercenary. Oh, just mercenary. All right. Pump it twice. Please pump it twice. Oh.
Yeah, he's not that good.
Or he's not that dumb.
Yeah, dumb.
Yeah.
Morphling and Aetherling are obviously both just insane.
What? He's leaving up the shroud.
Yep.
Oh boy. Ooh. He's at 20 though.
Yeah.
He can also give it flying? Although if he does that, then he's in trouble. So we just flunge with our flyers.
Yep.
All right. We are now in a Kervex torch race. Oh, sick.
Got him.
Ha! Hooked! Okay, I'm feeling a lot better now. The hooks.
I think that was a bad block on his part.
Unless he's got Force of Will? Alright, cool.
Alright.
What was the... TGVA? I don't know. I don't know how far down a Chronosutter would have to go to make it better than Griptide.
All right, you're up.
I'm just trying to figure out if... Oh, I can't cast it. All right, so... No. Okay. Do I Plane Cycle or do I actually just cast that guy?
We might want to just cast it. Unfortunately, we're... he's got us on a bit of a clock with the mercenaries here. Ooh, that is not good.
Wait, that kills his mercenaries, though. That kills all our goblin tokens and all our birds, but that kills both his shadow creatures.
True.
That seems really bad for him. Like, is that's better for us, isn't it?
Probably just because we don't, have any way of blocking his shadow guys. I mean, it leaves him with a 4/4 and a 1/2 that he can discard too, but that's probably fine. It only leaves us with 2 or 3 creatures though.
Yeah. But how big can you make the Tog right now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He can make this 7 power?
Yeah.
Man, we're close to being able to just torch this.
Just flunge with tokens?
I think we just swing with all our 1/1s.
Sure, go for it.
I'm probably going to play just the Harrier this turn. Or actually, I guess I'll play the Templar. Okay.
Okay.
Why is he doing that? So, hang on. Oh, because his mercenaries died. Okay. Darn, I was like, wait, can we torch this now? Because he's got 1 damage marked on him, but he can still make it... He can now give it...
Can he only do that 4 times?
Wait, what the...
What?
Shouldn't this still be a 2-3?
It should be, yeah. That's weird.
Weird. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, so the Tog would survive the -1/-1. Oh, because he's got -1/-1. Wait, we can kill it now.
Yeah.
We can actually torch this and kill it.
Yeah.
Oh, we should probably just do that. Sorry, I forgot about how the Death's Head Buzzard interacts.
Yeah.
Because he's got 2 cards in hand, so he can give this +1/+2, and then he'll have enough to give it 3, 4, 5. So it'll be a 7, but with 1 damage marked on it, and we can do...
No, we can only do 5. Yeah, we need to torch it for 6, right? We can only torch for 5.
But then he's pitched his whole hand and his graveyard?
Yeah, I mean, that's not the worst.
Eric the Watcher? Yeah, we'll be streaming something, I think, actually. Wait, that's this weekend?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll find time to stream.
Yeah, we'll stream something. All right, so don't then.
Yeah, just, play Templar or pass.
All right. No, 5 is not enough.
No, because when he discards the cards from his hand to give it +1/+1, it gives him more cards in the graveyard to exile as well.
Yeah.
So he can pump it twice, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, 5 times. So.
Yeah.
Making it a 6/7. So.
Yeah, we'll save the torch for
the race is a better.
For the race to the face. What is this? Oh God, are you the one that has Laquatus as champion? And he's left up the region. Wow. Called it, I guess. Well, if we top deck our other Chain Lightning, we can kill this guy. Just 2-for-1 ourselves. Right, Unspoken Kibbles? Right? Sometimes I really hate calling it. So, Psychotog. So he can discard 2, he can give it +1/+2, and it's then fine. 3, 4, 5. So this can be 6 here.
Which seems kind of bad. I think we probably just want to block.
Do we just put both Chiefs and the Templar in front of it?
Well, don't we just put... to just kill it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, do it. Wait, is that enough? 2, 5, 6, 7 Yeah, it is.
It's enough. And he'll kill either the Templar or both chiefs.
Yeah. Or just block with Faithful.
I guess.
I mean, if we just block with Templar, he has to... Well, no, that doesn't work, because he just... Well, he can't kill it without discarding his entire hand, right?
Yeah. So well, if we block just with the Templar, then...
Like, he can't kill it without discarding his two cards and exiling all but one card from his graveyard.
Mm-hmm. Like, without discarding his hand, he can pump it twice.
Kesedric Life Loss is pretty good, yeah.
Do it. Triple block, make him work for it. Make him pump, kill later. I don't know. I actually don't know what I want to do here.
The right plays here. I'm down with trying to triple block.
All right. All right, Mango Man, welcome to the channel. Let's listen to your advice. I think it's a close argument. I don't know. I don't actually know which is better.
Okay.
Like, this does take everything. Okay. So right now he's still only killing one chief.
Discard Swamp.
Okay.
Now he can kill both chiefs. Which is looking what he's going to do.
Okay. I think I'm okay with that. Oh, that guy.
That guy's not that good.
Not that great here. I think we can bait him into using the regen on Laquatus' champion.
By?
Attacking with Templar. He's got Vigilance.
Go for it. I mean, the worst thing he does is blocks with Kesedrix.
And then nothing happens.
And nothing happens.
Yeah, I think that was actually a pretty sweet trade. All things considered. Also, if he takes this? No. Yeah. Okay.
He saw the line. All right, so just play the hit for the flyer?
I think so, yeah.
Hmm. Oh, good. He has another Psychotog.
Oh, great. Great. That's great. That's awesome.
Yeah, that's pretty much... That's pretty bad.
That's super great. I'm so excited about this.
Dear God.
Really?
Yeah. Why wouldn't you attack there?
I don't know.
I think just throw the Faithful in front of it.
Yeah.
We saw a couple of the... what's it called? The lose four life discard or psychic creature from Conspiracy going around.
Oh, Tyrant's Choice?
Yeah. Blech. So if he has one of those, we die.
That's cool, actually. Because I can block and then give it pro black.
Yep.
Can I attack with this? Do I need the chump ears?
You Chumpy might need McGee's. The chumpers.
I think so. Yeah. I think we got a pass. All right.
Torch is a fireball.
Yeah, Torch is a sorcery. Torch is not an instant. Torch is, it's just a fireball, except it has this thing that it makes it harder to counter.
Yeah.
So as long as it's on the stack, spells that target it cost 2 colorless more, but otherwise it's just X and red deal X damage to creature or player. It's, yeah.
It's a fireball that can't be split, but it's hard to target.
Okay. No.
Man. Darn. All right, that didn't help us at all. All right, well. That didn't actually help us that much. No, I didn't want to play Stoic Champion because
then we couldn't
have cast a Chroma's Blessing.
Yeah.
Black. Got to select that correctly. Well, that play didn't actually do anything. It just extended everything for a turn. So that's fun, I guess. Oh, well, I mean, he blocks forever.
Yep. Yeah, you're just playing them out.
Yeah. Is there an argument to torch something? To try and torch Kezidrix or torch Psychotog? Because he can only make it... He's 1-2.
He can make
3,
it...
3-4. He can give it 4, so 6. So we can't kill it? Alright. Alright, so Deathblade Elite... Alright, hell with it. I'm attacking with the Harrier.
Even if he's not playing Tyrant's Choice, I'm not super crazy about going to 4 with his board state.
Yeah, and people do play Tyrant's Choice.
Yeah, it's a...
In blue-black. Especially in a deck like this. Like, he's playing an aggressive deck. People definitely play it.
Yes, attack with just that, please.
And attack. And pass priority.
Come on.
And pass priority.
Nice.
Yes. Yeah, we do need to just get him into torch range.
Yep. That is our game plan. What, he won game one, right? Or is this game one?
This is game one.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
It's a slow game.
Okay. I kind of would rather... Ugh. Yeah, I think we just cycle it, right?
I think so.
Just hope for something else. Yeah.
Because I don't think... So we get him to 9 and then to 7. And that still doesn't help because then we only are still torching for 6. So it doesn't actually change the torch clock. So let's cycle it. Oh, that's fun too.
Yeah.
Can't play it right now though because we got to keep Deathblade mana open. It does feel like 2 games. Aquamaba. Aquamaba. So, oh, there we go. Yikes. Okay.
And you're just blocking Kezidrix and...
How big can the Psychotog get?
4, 5, 6, 7. If we do that, we're losing our... I mean, he has to pump it a lot.
So I guess we actually block the...
Yeah, we block Psychotog with and just take
Templar,
4.
Yeah. Okie dokie. Aquamel Biawawa. Yeah, let's do this now.
Yep. If the Templar survives this, like, it looks like he's only going to pump enough so that the Psychotog doesn't die.
Yeah, he can't.
If the Templar survives, we may be able to, like, bodyguard, give Templar pro blue, and hit for 5 and then torch him.
Yep.
Like, we might actually have him here.
Depends what his last card is.
Well, we're not going to find out. Yet. So, bodyguard, Templar, hit for 5, get him to 4, torch.
Or burn him out. Yeah,
I think that's the only way we're going to win.
Yep, go for it.
All right. Whoop!
Yeah, I mean, if he has counterspell, then he has counterspell.
Blue.
Oh, yeah, provoke.
I guess
provoke would have worked
well, the same way. Okay. True. Yeah, he could have circular logic. It's true. But I feel like if he's going to do something, he's going to do it now.
All right, go for it. Are we dead if he has the counter here?
We're not totally dead. Is it circular logic? Really?
He got it. All right.
Man. All right. Yeah, he can't cast literal counterspell. It's true. Somehow forget how to do this properly. Oh, okay. Dope. You may pay 3 to prevent this. I cannot do that.
So we block there and we block there. No, we're dead.
Are we?
Yeah, because he discards a card to Aquamoeba, swings with everything. Oh, no, we're not. Yeah, we are, aren't we?
I didn't call circular logic. Someone else did. James called. I think James called that one.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure if he discards.
I think 4 go to 2, and then that's it. So we need to block. What do we need to block? If he discards, he can only discard to one of these.
Yeah, but if he discards
makes
to
it,
that
makes it 3.
If he discards to this, it's a 3/1. He can make this a 3 power. Yeah, so even if we block these... Oh, I guess if we block these two, we take 6, which is exact. Sorry, I thought we were at 7.
No, because he can't pump both of them.
Why not?
He can... Oh.
He can
exile. Yep. No, you're... Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right.
So we do that. So now he has to discard and exile both cards, but he will do that because I think he knows what he's doing.
I think that was the right play, though.
I mean, if we had played a game already and we knew we had that, I would maybe think about playing around it, but this is the first game.
Yeah, it doesn't feel like remember, it, but this is only game 1.
He has a dark ritual.
Cabal ritual. What?
And he does that, and he does it again. Alright, so I think that was pretty good.
Really drenched in sweat. Our opponent just said, literally drenched in sweat. And I said, it's pretty tense over here, too.
Okay. Probably bring in that aftershock again. That card kind of kills things.
Falter?
No, I don't think we're really...
What did we take out for that last time?
The Elite, but...
Oh, no, we took out the Armageddon.
Oh, yeah.
I think Armageddon's good here.
Pretty good here, is it not?
I think. Two Psychotogs. Two. Yeah, can we draw the Astro Slide for the second time in the whole event? Yeah, that'd be nice. Well, it only kills the Morphling and the Champion if he doesn't have mana up to regenerate or give them Shroud, irrespectively. I got that backwards. Geddon feeds his togs, but... yeah. So, Armageddon, yes or no? Keep Geddon. Good and bad against Psychotog, but good against his regen guys. That's true. I think I'm going to keep Armageddon. I think we'll take out something else. We need that whole game to get ripped apart by a lightning rift.
I wish.
Dude, I don't know, Mango Man. I've never played with Armageddon before. Outside of, like, maybe a cube draft once.
Cut the Armageddon.
Alright.
Go. Let's
see. What was pack one, pick one? Keeping it! Keeping it!
Could be interesting.
I'm gonna play one of these steps.
Yep.
Slide over here. That was a strange choice of mine. All right. Okay. Come on, any land. Turn three. Don't him me, bro.
Oh. Well.
Oops. I just said, dude, not cool.
Well, there goes our whole game. Our whole freaking game.
I just said, not cool, dude.
I mean...
Dude, not cool.
He has to take the torch, though, right?
I guess.
Well, I mean, if he doesn't take torch, then we get the whatever else he takes back.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
No, of course he takes slide.
But now we can get it back.
Yeah. If we draw a red here. Which we don't.
We can, yeah, cycle. Ooh, do that.
All right. Fine. None of us are allowed to have any fun. No one ever gets to have fun. Don't him now. That him went so late, he could easily have it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, doesn't look like it. Are we cycling the step here?
I think I'm going to cycle a Chroma's Blessing.
Oh, yeah, yeah, do that.
Dang it.
Alright.
I think now I'm playing this step.
You have to play the step, yeah. That's fine. We draw a land next turn, we're in actually pretty good shape.
Yeah. If we get to go screeching, then that'd be fine. That's fine. Let that be your whole turn. Yes. And... okay. It's, yeah. Land. Don't even have anything to cycle or cast. I can do literal nothing this turn.
Yep.
All right. Uh-oh.
Ooh, Dark Ritual.
Is this just Kezdrix? Can I please stop being right?
That seems actually not, like... Seems... What do we get here? Well, we can get our Astral Slide back.
What is better for us?
And start... He starts taking four from Kezdrix. Of course, so do we, but...
No, because we have a creature. He only takes 4 if we don't have creatures. Oh, you mean we start blinking our Deathblade Elite so that we don't have creatures at the beginning of his upkeep? But then he keeps hitting us for 4.
Yeah.
Blowing up our creature doesn't work because he's already winning the race.
Yeah. Maybe just play out the Battle Screech and...
Then pay to untap this guy next turn and then flash it back. I think we just kill this thing.
Go for it.
I mean,
the other option is, yeah, play the one form gain life.
Psych him out. Can't cast it this turn anyway. Alright. We got the slide. We've got Tarot's Faithful. Let's start getting goofy.
He's also just stuck on no lands here.
Yeah, which is great for us. Don't do it.
Unless, nope, he doesn't. Okay.
Not this turn. Okay. Still can't actually... God, we're going to go to 9 before we get to start sliding stuff.
If he doesn't draw land, I think we're okay.
Would it be better just to play the Faithful this turn?
Gain 4.
And then go back to 13?
Probably, yeah.
And then hopefully draw a land so that we can slide or... Yep. I think we'd better to use up all 4 of our manas here. So we're not going to block. We're going to go back down to 13. But this way, if we draw a land, we can slide and cycle right away. I mean, we can actually block with the Faithful and then bounce it, which would be sweet. Damn it. All right, let's just screech then and start chomping.
Yep. We are at 9 minutes.
Whatever.
That'll get awkward if we win this game.
Yeah. Let's not get ahead of ourselves.
He's also just not drawing land, which is... kind of shitty for him, but kind of good for us.
That's why we strip mine.
Oh.
Cycling. Oh, dang it. If we'd had the slide out. All right, so he got his island.
Yep. Snap block.
Yeah, I don't feel like going to 9. All right. Sweet. So, what we're going to do here is block with the Faithful, plane cycle, and then before damage, bounce the Faithful, gain 4 life, block for free. Luckily, you can't counter an ability, and cycling is an ability. Well, you can,
you
but
can.
Not with these cards.
Yeah. Battle Screech is a really good card.
Battle Screech is not what you would call a fair card. What is this?
Ooh!
Repulsion. All right. Well, the block still works.
All right, well.
That's kind of spicy.
Game 4 life.
Wait, what? Oh, because we cycled, so it goes away.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so we drew a Chroma's Blessing instead. But that's fine, because we have Stoic Champion and a Cycler. So we can't actually block it. Oh, well.
Probably
what
just...
the, Metonymic human.
Hey.
Metonymic human. Has just subscribed. Metonymic human, thank you for subscribing.
Alright, so what? Attack with some birds?
Yeah. Yeah, attack with the birds. And then I don't know what we do.
Well, I mean, I think we just do the same block and slide thing.
Actually, I think I'm going to cycle now and bounce my Deathblade Elite.
Yeah.
Get it back now, and then we can block with it.
Mm-hmm.
So let's do that. Cycle. It's a shame to lose out on a Stoic Champion activation, but whatever. I do wish to use that ability. And we get to cycle, and we draw. Hey, there we go. Tarot's Faithful. And okay. And this comes back. So cool. This will block Khazad-Dricks all day long.
Yep.
Not a fast deck, this one that we're running. Okay, he's got 5 mana now, so he's got to be close to, like, something scary. Icarid. 3-1 haste. The beginning of the end step, sacrifice Icarid. If it's at the beginning of your upkeep, if it's in your graveyard, you can exile a black creature card other than Icarid from your graveyard and return Icarid to the battlefield. So Icarid's never going away.
No.
So that's fun. Really?
Jerk.
Wow.
Okay, this got bad.
Boy.
Whoa.
Bold.
It's such a bad block, but...
Can we take 7?
I mean, we can, but it seems kind of bad for us.
Getting 4 back next turn.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess we're taking 7 here. Yeah, Icarid. Wow. Yeah, I'm still not paying, because if we get a mountain, I want a Fire Blast. That doesn't count. All right, so this will work. Like, this will help a lot. Yeah. Faithful, get in there. Okay, so we gain 4. So we're going to have to deal with Khazad-Dricks and Icarid. Wish I'd killed that.
I don't think...
I think we just swing out with everything but the Faithful.
Yep.
Do the block slide thing. And we're going to take 3 off the Icarid, but we'll gain 4 from the Faithful, so...
We will gain 1, basically.
Yeah. Then we get our Zealot down, and it's going to be pretty close to Threshold.
It will be.
Oh, a black creature from his graveyard. Okay, he's got 1.
Yeah.
He only gets to do this once.
The Zealot will be online next turn.
Sweet.
Psychotog.
That's less good, but we have a plan. 3 turns in the air, and we get him. We just got to hold on.
Well, I mean, if we draw...
More than that, actually, because Mystic Zealot will have flying, so only 2 turns in the air, really. Yeah. We're getting no value off the Stoic Champion here.
No.
Hey, sick.
Okay, he's at that.
I don't think we can win a game with this deck in less than 5 minutes, by the way.
No, we can't.
Probably just going to sack the mountains to kill Khazad-Dricks, by the way.
Well, just 1 second. So if we do that... We get in for... How much are we getting in here for?
3 in the air. We can't attack with champion. It's just throwing it away.
No, I'm just wondering if we can get him down to 4, because then we could just fire blast him.
No, because he'll block the champion.
Yeah, but just swing out with the birds and play zealot. And he's dead next turn. Wait, so if we attack, he blocks there. He takes 4. He goes to 5. Yeah.
How do we have him dead if we want?
If he blocks it.
Oh, if we'd paid for this?
Oh, yeah. Shit.
Oh. Well.
Crap.
Oops. Dang it.
That's fine. We're fine.
Yeah, he's not dead. Yet.
There is not a second draft, no.
He will be dead.
Yeah, if we had untapped with that guy, we would have had enough. That's fine.
The round timer is on the left-hand side. It's right here and right here. So he can't bring Icarid back, so that's nice.
No, I think we win. I mean,
yeah, I've won games with less than 5 minutes on the clock, but
I don't think this deck
not with a deck like this. I don't think we're going to win game 3. But who knows? First, we've got to win this game. Yeah, so he's just dead in the air. So interesting. So what, like choking tethers or what? I'm not paying to untap here either. If he kills the zealot, he's still dead. Okay, so he's just letting us use our clock up. All right.
I think we run it back and just play.
Yep.
Go.
All right, let's be quick. It's true. If we go like trooper, battle screech, we could win real quick. Just like draw our most aggressive hand. So I don't know that we're actually drafting. We're going to be streaming M15 tomorrow. Yeah.
Sure.
Keep it. Our opponent's mulliganing as well.
Strip mine.
I mean,
he mulliganed?
Yeah.
Do it.
All right. It's so bad.
Ew.
It's so bad. All right.
Bodyguard.
Bodyguard? Don't we play like a step first? Fine.
I don't. Well, yeah, I guess so. Yeah, whatever.
Time to be aggressive.
Ah, crap.
You be quiet, Eric the Orange.
Sure. Okay, it's game over.
Fine. Whatever, what's he going to take here? We don't actually have a great plan at the moment.
I mean, again, he has to take Spark Spray.
He can't trade for the guard, so that's exciting.
That hurt to watch. That's fair. Yeah, Spark Spray. All right, so now we have to play a wall, or a step.
All right, guys, we got him on a 20-turn clock.
Play. Go.
Probably just going to be cycling a Chroma's Blessing here.
Oh, we're dead.
we got a Wall of Diffusion. I can do this now so I can... F6. Oh, my God, really? All right. Mountain.
Hey.
Sick.
Go.
Don't kill it. Turn clock. Now that's what I call inevitability. Icarid? Gaw. Alright. Well, at least he can't bring it back. Oh yeah, that. Forgot we had that.
It's actually kind of useful.
I guess. It helps him bring Icarid back, but whatever. Yeah, all right. I'm just going to kill the fiend with it, then. Get our Spark Spray. Spark Spray kills this. Sure, he gets Icarid, but we can block it.
Yeah, go.
Ow. That hurt me. Why do you hurt me so?
That's funny. Alex also walked into the office today with four Icarids.
What? Why?
For his Manaless Dredge deck.
What? Alex is building Manaless Dredge?
Yep.
What a hateful man.
Yeah.
Oh. Bye-bye, bodyguard. Can't sack that wall. That wall is keeping us alive.
I think you just spray that now.
If I do it now, then he'll be able to bring Icarid back.
Oh, I guess that's true, yeah.
This blocks his predatory night stalker at least. Yeah. You know, the real trick is astral sliding your opponent's predatory night stalker. God damn it, that thing. Eat that thing. Does it get tapped every turn? It doesn't untap. Okay, so I only have to pay to untap it once? Fine, done. I'll do that.
Yeah, see if we'll pay for the mana.
I doubt it. He knows we have Spark Spray.
Yeah.
Yeah, right. Psychotog. Hooray. Oh, neat. Look at that. So it's not going well.
He's got zero cards in his hands.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, it's not the worst. I mean, got the Icarid coming back this turn, but that's fine.
I mean, he'll have one card in his hand, but that's fine.
It's whatever. Oh, he opted not to. Okay, fine.
You got that's kind of annoying.
Yeah.
Because we would have cycled that and turned on our Zealot.
Hmm.
So now we're just both top decking.
Except I have 2 minutes and 42 seconds on the clock. Though he's catching up. Oh, sick. Yeah, that doesn't matter because it's already untapped.
Cycle that.
Yeah, Forgotten Cave.
And that puts our 3/3 flyer.
Ah.
Oh, shit.
Next turn.
Okay, that's fine. Attack.
Yeah, I'm going to attack with this then.
F6.
Yep.
F6. Okay. Is it actually looking kind of good for us right now?
It's not looking great for us, but it's looking fine.
I
think it's looking better for us than it is. I think we're in a better spot right now than he is.
If we get to resolve BBC next turn, we'd be pretty happy about that.
Go. Oh.
Okay.
Shit.
I'll probably just be paying for that. Only gotta pay for it once.
If we attack
right.
Then we have to...
Right. I knew that.
So...
Okay.
Wall on...
Block.
Block. And, yeah, block there, yeah.
Because he actually can't make...
Can't make Psychotog bigger. All right, we need to...
All right, I guess I'm not paying this turn, and I'm just going to BBC then.
Yeah.
Oh, good. He has to put the triggers on the stack. That's fun. Which one's this? Oh, it's that one. Go away. Well, it doesn't actually matter in this case. It's both of them. I'm not paying for either of them. Ooh, Gust Cloak. Maybe I wanted to play that instead.
Probably. Nah, that's fine.
No, because this way I still get to leave up Deathblade. Next turn I can pay to untap, maybe draw a land, and get to Gust Cloak as well.
I don't know what he drew there.
Of course we don't know what he drew. It's in his hand. A Chroma does make Paralyze fall off. That is true.
So you're paying for this?
Yeah, I'm going to pay for the Zealot. And hope I get a land to also play Gust Cloak. And if not, we still get to use Deathblade Elite.
Super intense, low time drafting.
Go faster. Ow.
Opponent is now below 5 minutes.
Okay, not paying for that one. Paying for that one. Sick.
Alright. Yeah, I think we are in pretty good shape here. Obviously, it depends on what he draws, but you're pretty good.
Thank you, Bahra Knows Best. I have goblins that I will jump with.
Just nothing. That looks pretty good for us then. And we're paying for it again.
Not that one.
Not that one, yeah.
Oh, wow.
Three. Wait.
What?
If we attack with everything, he blocks. He takes three. No, that's enough. Sorry.
Save it. We get him next turn.
Yep.
I've been unparalyzing dudes, yo.
Yeah, that's how we're gonna win. Sons of Bilgod.
Right? That's okay, because you can't make it fly this turn.
Yep. We got it. Wow, we actually won that.
I think. I mean, we've got a minute and a half left. Something could happen.
Right, we only need to do one attack here.
Pass. Yes, and he's tapped out.
Yeah.
Yes. Just don't have the Force of Will.
No, Force of Will would be... Well...
Even then, I think we're pretty okay. We're not dead on the crackback if he has Force of Will. Oh, sick. That's even better. Whatever, I'm just going to play it safe.
Of course we win this game. It's preordained that Lur must always go 2-1. It's true. Look, we got...
Especially if there's, like, no time on the clock.
Got there. Yes! Oh, got it. Nice. Oh, we can win with that deck in less than 5 minutes, apparently. Apparently we can.
Oh man.
It only took like 4 minutes.
Well, that was fun.
Yeah.
Oh, you need to pay one life for Force of Will? Oh, neat.
I forgot about that.
Oh yeah, you would. Completely forgot about paying one life for Force of Will.
That was game 3. Sweet!
Christ.
We got there. Or I guess we goat there.
Look. Look at our background. It's the Boros punching the blue in the face.
Goat, 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 goat.
That's so many goats, James.
So many goats. All right. That will be it for this evening, boys mm-hmm. and girls. Well, I guess for now.
For magic, anyway.
Man.
I'm going to...
For a long time.
Yeah. We're going to take the thing offline. I'm going to go and... we're going to be offline for like 10 minutes. I'm going to run to the corner and get some food. And then going to come back and I'm going to play some Deus Ex Human Revolution. Be a little bit more chill this evening. Hooray. I'm such a luck turd.
You are.
James, we completely...
We luck turded out
on that. We luck sagged into that game. Hey, thanks all. Thanks so much for watching our Magic stream. Remember cardkingdom.com. Check them out. Let them know that we sent you if indeed you decide to check to do that. Going to play some quick commercials while we change over to my stream. The stream will go offline and it'll come back on and I'll be playing some Deus Ex. So if you like that, stick around. If not, thank you so much for joining us. Probably going to be a bonus stream of M15 this weekend because it's pre-release.
Yeah, I could see it happening on Saturday.
Follow the channel. Keep an eye out for it. And we'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching. Especially to the new folks.
Yeah, thank you to everybody new.
Later. Why does it say that still? That's not true.
Because you didn't save it.
I didn't save it. Okay, that's not the show that it'll be...